God will ask Nigerians, why are you crying? We are crying because our leaders have failed us woefully. Let me tell you, if it is in a civilized country, by now, President Buhari will resign. Put me anywhere and let the whole world hear it. By now, with what is happening, President Muhammadu Buhari should honorably resign. We are crying because we don't have a shepherd. But those that will fight what I'm saying now will eventually suffer the wrath. If you can't do it, either you resign or you'll be changed. A good coach cannot watch his team defeated when he has players sitting down watching at the bench. Either Buhari resigned by himself or he will be impeached. This statement is too mysterious and supernatural. You know that many people begin to fight it. And back then, did you not pray for Buhari? Did someone not anoint Saul? What are you talking about? Am I the creator of Buhari? God created him. Nigerians trusted him because he did well sometime. But now, how can people be dying? The chief security officer, consultant of lies of the country, will be sitting down, not making any comments. Gunmen attacking everybody everywhere. Amen. Why are you crying, Nigerian youths? As I said, overseas have become dumping ground for our ingenious youths. Young men, young doctors, lawyers, everybody running away from Nigeria. Countries we are better off. Just coming back from Eboy to this place. You need to visit Eboy.
Oh, hey Biafra, once again, this is a very short awareness. By right, I don't supposed to come here and talk about Mbaka. I would have talked about Mbaka on a very high, deep way if Facebook didn't block my main page, my main profile, and some other substitute, I could say, platforms by which I use. I think now Facebook, they are after me. I think they sense my voice, they use my voice to lock all my things. But this one, as I could say, it is unknown to them. Only God has done it. Now, somebody sent me a message on my inbox and said that Mazen Nnamdi will not like us to talk about the issue of Mbaka. I said, well, to myself, Mazen Nnamdi did not send me a message on my boss to not talk about Mbaka. But you know one thing, Mbaka, anywhere you are, hearing the sound of my voice, about many years ago, about, let me say, 8, 7, 10 years ago, BBC came online when you started your saga. And BBC, an Igbo man, a musician, and of course, a musical activist, he opened a very, very, he started, I could say, he played a very nice music, which he titled that music with your name, Mbaka. And by that time, BBC titled that particular broadcast, which he did in combination with his music, Mbaka Why. This is past about 8 years, 9 years ago that BBC come online with Mbaka Why. And many people called him all kinds of names. Many of the talk of Mbaka called BBC all kinds of names. They give him a name. You are talking to a man of God. You are insulting a man of God. My sister Ejire from Cologne. God bless you. And Obi Sarge, a long time, and also AGK Ibe. God bless you for being here. I want to talk about Mbaka. I am not coming here to say Mbaka why. I am coming to ask Mbaka, are you repenting or you are about to repent? Mbaka, This is, I am going to ask Mbaka four questions. I don't care how many people who is here on the platform, I know Mazo Kongo. Whenever time Facebook releases me, I'm still going to push this message upward. Mbaka, let me ask you something. Mbaka, are you apologizing to Pierre France and Akuse IPOBs, or you apologizing to Mazen Nnamdi Kanu? Mbaka, please, we want you to go inside and lock yourself, according to the book of Isaiah, which said, go ye, my people, and lock yourself until the calamities are over. Mbaka, let me tell you something. We all are ordained man of God. You know, I am very, very sorry for those church members, those who are echoing amen. Amen. Let it be so. When Mbaka try to hypnotize them in the church. You know, one of the problems that the black people have, as our leader Mazen Nnamdi Kanu has taught us in the University of Radio Biafra, that the black man is insane. Black man is have a leakage of memory. Black people, we don't read. Black people, we don't keep records. That is why Mbaka will come boldly and try to brainwash people. Mbaka did not come for you. I want to tell you, Mbaka, I want you to come out and tell us, my sister Wakego, I'm asking Mbaka, is he repenting or he's about to repent? It's unfortunate. Yesterday night, I saw when my brother Patrick and Mazi Solomon, my brothers, they are streaming the issue and analyzing Mbaka. I was totally upset. I was brutally upset. But one of the things I want to ask Mbaka, Mbaka, what have come over you? Are you sleeping or you're still dreaming? This is not the scenario, or I could say the topic, which was preached by BBC, which he titled Mbaka Why. But Mbaka, my question from myself to you is this. Are you repenting or you want to repent? Are you apologizing to the Igbo race? Or you are asking Mazen Nnamdi Kanu to forgive you? Mbaka, let me tell you, many of your fellow pastors have repented long time ago. Mbaka, you are saying that you are castigating Buhari. Mbaka, do you remember when you changed Buhari in the expense of Jonathan? Mbaka, Mbaka, before you apologize to the indigenous people of Biafra, I want you to look for the address of Goodluck Jonathan or his wife or his concubines, or it doesn't matter. Go to them. Mbaka, you have to go back. Mbaka, do you know that you have committed sacrilege? Mbaka, do you know that you have two tongues? Mbaka, there is a sweetness in your mouth, but what comes out of your tongue is more dangerous than venom of a viper. Mbaka, let me tell you, you are a fearful man. Mbaka, you are not a man enough. Mbaka, the way you preached, the way you fight for Nigerian government, Mbaka, we want you to show us your children. Mbaka, the way you politicize everything, the way you preach, the way you fight, the way you lie, shows us that you are defending your treasure somewhere with your wife and your children. Mbaka, I am also calling the Catholic organizations, the Roman Catholic organizations, to look into this, to Mbaka. All of you have to look into the life of Mbaka. Mbaka seems like he's marrying two wives somewhere with the children. The way he pursued the things about this life. I am standing here to tell you people that Mbaka is not a straightforward person. You know, but you know, the average Nigerians, and of course in Enugu, those people who come to your adoration grant, you can be able to brainwash them because of the cookies, chewing gums, granite that you are given unto them. Mbaka, that is why you are able to accumulate the brain, the mindset of our people, and an average Enugu person who are coming to your direction grant has forsaken what you said last time about Buhari, about the IPOB, about Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, and about Nigerians, and are not echoing amen to your sentence. Simply mean that Ejike Mbaka, either you are serving Satan or you are serving a god, a foreign god that we do not know. Mbaka, let me ask you, let me pull a sentence from what you have said on this particular message, Mbaka. Mbaka, you said that People come to your church to give testimony for they have acquired a Ghana visa. But I want to tell you, Mbaka, not only Ghanaian visa. Mazin Nanakala, our leader, Mbaka, put this in your score, because everything that Mazin Nanakala said 10 years ago is what you are saying now, because out of fear. We know who you are. You are speaking out of fear, Mbaka. Mbaka, we want you to come out and apologize to our leader. Don't pray that side prayer. We don't accept it. I want to tell you, Mbaka, because the way you are talking seems that you want to repent, but you don't know how to repent. Mbaka, Mbaka, I need to lay hands on your head and remove this spirit of viper tongue, because you are a deception in the land of Igbo land. If you don't know it now, Mbaka, so you are afraid like this, Mbaka. I am already self and Mbaka Buizbuto Nyujo. Yesterday, I've seen the issue you are discussing, Mbaka. But I want to tell you something, Mbaka. Mbaka is the main problem. Mbaka is now, I could say, accelerating himself from the issue of Buhari. But as long as I'm concerned, Facebook can track me, do anything they like with all my pages. But one thing that I know is, even if it is one person that I see on my platform, they can never stop me. I have, they said now, all my pages, I have 14 days to go. So therefore, I'm about to be released. Yes, I agree to you, Kenechi. So one of the things is this. Mbaka has to come out and tell us why you loji. Mbaka has married. Mbaka Jumwaka. Mbaka is a married man. The way he comes into the affairs of the civilians shows us, Mbaka, you are not fulfilling the promises of God. So therefore, Mbaka, is your name meaning you will have a Catholic church? Mbaka, you are one of the people that have made a lot of people to die by voting Buhari. Mbaka, don't you even, Mbaka, is your name causing the downfall of Nigeria? When you will set a devil on your pulpit and declare that Buhari is a God sent, Mbaka, I wonder what you have drunk. Mbaka, you will rum. Mbaka, something either, Mbaka, is either you have a deformation of memory, more is schizophrenic. Let me tell you, Mbaka was the one who voted Jonathan, who demoted Jonathan, so to say, sorry, and bring Buhari, which is dead. Mbaka knows how to sandwich his message. Almost they say brainwash people. He knows how to brainwash people, because he have go back to all these sentences that Mbaka is making. You will see what Mbaka is preaching. He's defending himself upon everything he has lied about. Mbaka tried to defend himself. First of all, he started telling us that the reason why God gave him a promise is it not Samuel that ordained Saul, and after that Saul, in other words, he is now justifying himself that God sent him to call Buhari, and now he's bringing the blame on Buhari. But Mbaka, there is another thing that this your God does not show you. Mbaka, you are a liar. Mbaka, we are the Canaanites. We know by every indication that there's no man called Buhari. Mbaka, I want to tell you that the God you're serving under the Catholic Church is blind God. Mbaka, the more you talk, if I am you, I will go inside the toilet. I will go inside the toilet. In fact, go back to your shrine and lock yourself and stop talking. Mbaka, when you say Buhari have to resign, it's another offense to the indigenous people of Biafra and Igbo land. Those who know the truth, Mbaka, you are a liar. Stop brainwashing the church. Stop brainwashing people who don't have data, people who are not socialized, people who don't know what is called telephone, people who are not in this civilized world. What Mbaka used to brainwash the people is, I am a man of God. God call me. Mbaka, you are a very big disgrace. Because of the revolution have started, Mbaka, there is no amount of deception you come here to preach that will let us to go back. Mbaka, we have drawn the line. The line of forgiveness have closed. So if we forgive Mbaka, if we go out for what Mbaka is saying, means Udele, is Udele, Chukwumadike, Uchemefo, Obidobienu, they will also come back tomorrow, and those who killed our brother, Zona Boy, and I could say, yes, I will. They will also come back and preach to us also, then we will forgive. Then, Mbaka, I'm telling you, there is no amount of deception. Put it in your tongue, Mbaka, you are a sinner. You are not repenting. Mbaka is the greatest sinner in the face of this universe. Mwabo pastor, evangelist, Dr. General Mazoko Gwadawagia. Mbaka is afraid of what is about to come. Mbaka, let me tell you. Mbaka, you see that now, people are coming to your church, thanking God in your church, in your adoration grant, because they have acquired a Ghana visa. Mbaka, can walk the truth. No, you didn't see it good. You haven't even seen it. Mbaka, very soon, nearest future, Mbaka, in the next 1 month, people will come to adoration grant to give testimony on how they get Sudan and the Somalia visa. Mbaka, so you let us succumb to everything that Mazen Nandakan has been preaching. Mbaka, you switch so fast. Mbaka, you just forget everything you have said. Mbaka, every time you are in the pulpit talking nonsense about Biafrans and about the Igbos and denying where you come from, there are people who God in your Ogugisi needed to everything you are saying. Mbaka, you are a very stupid man. Let me tell Mbaka, since yesterday night, I couldn't have time. Facebook is like, you people know what I will do. In this year of Igonso, Mbaka, let me tell you, do you know, when God sealed a covenant in the land of Israel, that night before the pledge, God will gather the people of Israel. He said, kill the lamb and spread the blood on the door, for I am coming to destroy the... Mbaka, man, the Bible. Can I tell you why Mbaka knows the Bible? He knows that there is a pledge that has been released from Chukwuka Biafra that is about to hit anybody that is anti-Biafra. Do you know what Mbaka did? He now metamorphosed, according to the book of Revelation chapter number 12, Mbaka want to answer the Son of God. He start to deny everything he said before. Mbaka is using God for his own benefit. I am telling all of you, even they will, because Facebook blocked me, I would have broadcast this thing in the whole general collaboration where the whole world will know who Mbaka is. He's a devil. Every church member, is, if you are still believing in Mbaka, and this man on about the major, all of you are evil. They are not sons and the sons of God. Mbaka will even up. Mbaka is a serpent. Mbaka bunojo. Mbaka had done. Mbaka does not go to church. Let me tell you, all the smart. Satan is using Mbaka. Mbaka was the one who said that Buhari is a gift from God, and now Mbaka have changed. So now, therefore, let's ask Mbaka a question. Mbaka, can there be no opportunity to give this message that Buhari is the prayer answered? Is it go? Mbaka, can there be no? Where were you? Is it not in the same adoration grant? Mbaka, is it not the same members that you are brainwashing? We have to be very, very, very sincere. Let me tell Mbaka, the curtain has drawn. Curtain, I bet you go, Mbaka is a sinner. Mbaka, don't come conny way to behave like if you love our leader, Mazen Nandakano. Mazen Nandakano has declared, now we are into revelation. Mbaka, the very smart, do you know why? Mbaka is some of the pastors in Nigeria, in the zoo, that are very, very smart. In the social network, Mbaka has went to Google and asked Google, what is a revolution? Google has told Mbaka what revolution is. That is why he see that he was very smart and begin to amend everything that he has said before. Begin to act like if he had the burden of the indigenous people of Biafra, where he's coming from. Mbaka is the most dangerous person you have to fear after Mbaka Adeboye. Let's hit the point. And now I will tell you, Mbaka, you see, this is your church. I am calling Pope, whichever Pope that is there. I am calling Rome. I am calling Roman Catholic people to demote Mbaka. Mbaka is a politician. Now, let me tell you, Mbaka, let me tell you people, you have to wake up, listen to this message, Sister Jiro. Is that it? Achom ki wure good message Mbaka. Analyze it, Kenechi, either. I want you people to go back to Mbaka message. Sometimes when I look here, I see two people standing on the platform of Mazoko, that man that Nigeria is after me. Man at a zoo are following my page. Facebook blocked me on everything. I still have 14 days, but this one they don't know. I want to open your eyes. Go back to the message of Mbaka. All right? Go back and listen. Mbaka is have been talking with Dave Omahi and the brother of Dave Omahi for 2023. Are you getting it now? Now, Mbaka brought hope was of them man. Hope was of them man. I am a low man. I'm telling you what I know. Mbaka brought hope before Buhari and the Sultan of Sokoto with Mbaka in Afoketana. It was an old arrangement on how hope was of them man will take over Imo State. You see this thing that Mbaka is doing? Mbaka is having trouble as I'm talking to you right now from Buhari, the second, the number 17 Buhari, all right, about what he said. As I'm talking to you right now, Mbaka no wo, he knows what I'm saying. Mbaka is having problem the same way Channel TV were having problem. Is the same way Mbaka is having problem now, right now as I'm talking to you, for what he has said yesterday night. Do you know why? Mbaka received money to publish Buhari. Mbaka received money to use his foolish and dumb and uneducated congregation to pull up a crowd. Oh God, I don't know. I'm about to say Mbaka is the main problem of Igbo land as I'm talking to you now. Do you know why? Immediately Mbaka heard revolution, Mbaka went to the dictionary and began to search out what the revolution is. Mbaka knows that the revolution is bloody. Whether you're a pastor, whether you're a church person, whether you are. In fact, I want you to go back and listen to my brother Lion Man. You put on my Lion Man. Say, go back to Lion Man, and I want SS Honey TV to stream the message of my brother Lion Man. Lion Man, after my Nandekano last broadcast, Lion Man came alive by the spirit of Elohim. I have never spoken to Lion Man, ask him, he will tell you. I listened to the message of my brother Lion Man. Lion Man spoke from the spirit of the Lord, and he mentioned about the evil, the sacrilege of Mbaka. And when Lion Man was speaking, if you want to know who I am, whether I'm a prophet or not, ask Lion Man, have Mazo Koko called you before? I have never called Lion Man. But when Lion Man was speaking, Elohim came to me and spoke to me that Lion Man is hitting Mbaka. After 13 hours of Lion Man going out of the stream, Mbaka knows. I was sitting here in my house. Let me tell us one thing, no, Namara, about Mazo Koko. I saw an arrow sent to me. That was on the King's Day. On the King's Day, I was sitting in my house here. I saw an arrow sent against me. When I saw the arrow bent like, I bent like this, the arrow passed on my head. Then I fell asleep. I saw Lion Man. I don't know Lion Man. I have never met him before. Only I used to see this guy on. I want to tell us a story. That's why you must share this thing back. Share this message now. For you to know, if you are an agitator, if you are following Biafra, if you are under the leadership of Mazen Nandekano, you must back yourself out, either with a native power or you enter into a re-covenant with Elohim. Aye. Oh God, Facebook, you are stupid, man. Is he Lion Man? That guy, Anna, or Lion Man, I have never met him before. I have never tell him that I'm saying. I have never met him. But the message the Lion Man preached after our leader declared this revolution, I see fire coming from the message of Lion Man about Mbaka. And I prayed on that message the Lion Man said. The next 8 hours, Mbaka started vomiting. When I'm from Mbaka, can't have me go too far. Mbaka is an evil man. Do you know Mbaka is a master of that something we call opium? He's an opium master, syncretism, brainwashing, Omar, because there are people that you have to fear in the area of theology and the Christology. Catholic priests, all the reverend priests in the Catholic, they study both esoterical and the demonology and every other thing. They are more powerful than any other priest in the whole world. But Mbaka was privileged to begin to use his own on the ministry with his name out of Roman Catholic. Can I tell you something? This man, Ephraim Abejike Mbaka, is a very dangerous man because he was able to break out from the, I could say, from the, how do I say it, from the ritual of the Catholics, and his anchoring himself with his ancient grandfather's power, with the lie. Mbaka, let me tell you, Mbaka, when Mbaka dies, we will understand there is a lot of things that are hidden under Mbaka. Because Facebook will block them. If Facebook did not block me, how many thousands of people that will come here and hear the truth, man, also the cocoa will tell you. One day, I schooled in Tricoma Bible School. I am a graduate of Bible school and I know how it works. The first thing Mbaka Merebo, when Mbaka searched, you know what is called revolution. Mbaka have studied the history of Jerry Lawrence. Mbaka know the history, what makes German great, what makes America who they are. Mbaka now studied the revolution, and also not only that, Mbaka have studied the history of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu and know that this is a man that is very straight, that everything that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu said, he must carry it out. That is why he overchanged his talk. Mbaka is serving Satan. If you are still going to that adoration ground, I call it an abomination ground. Cease from going there, because this revolution will enter, and after we must have been dealing with all the politicians, we are coming for the churches. Mbaka knows what is about to come. Now he is he want to camouflage and run away. Check all his sentences. Mbaka is a student of Radio Biafra. He knows. Mbaka have been consulting his oracle. He knows who Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is. Pass you people, but because Mbaka is a married man, let me tell you truth, by all indications. Now, if it's not, why is Mbaka so concerned about money? Why is he so greedy that he don't want a lot of certain things to be free? I wanted to share this movie. I wanted to stay here 10 minutes, but in this year of Ikonso, anybody who comes to lie to us must die on this platform. Let me tell you something, Mbaka is not a genuine man. Somebody sent me a message, said Mazi Nnamdi Kanu said we should not talk about this Mbaka. I said as long as Mazi Nnamdi Kanu just send it directly on my page, let me talk about Mbaka. Mbaka lied against Jonathan. Mbaka brought evil people to the church, and all the people that are in that particular adoration ground are blind. These are people who don't have data. Because of this thing that you see that Mbaka is doing, that is why every one of us that is listening to the sound of my voice, try to do something for your family. If there is any man, any woman in family that doesn't have a smartphone, buy a smartphone for your brother. Buy a smartphone for that your old mother. Buy a smartphone for everyone who is in your family. Do you know what we do? Try to charge data. Tell them to download Radio Biafra and ask them, please, my brother, or send them enough credit. Tell them to be listening to the Radio Biafra, they will be educated. Do you know why? One of the simple methods, the zoo, Buhari spirit, Mbaka, and all his collaborative enemies, idiots, are using is to take light from Nigeria to make things destroy. Mbaka is one of the agents of Buhari, if you don't know it now. Now, let me come. Mbaka said he went to Ebo State, right? Mbaka is working with Devo Mahi. If you don't know it now, Mbaka is out for campaigning 2023 election. That is why he was able to point to you that I went to Ebo State. Sometimes Ahmadike will say, how can I talk to my people? It's like I will kill myself. No, Mazi, you won't kill yourself. We will do this job together. I have to go. Revolution has started. Everyone you see that have cascaded Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, watch them. They will soon come out. And I want to tell every saboteur anywhere you are, get ready. If you are drinking beer, if you are smoking your Igbo, your cigarette, take it that it can be the last Igbo in your history of your life, and you get out of the body. That is what the revolution is all about. Mbaka knows that after the politicians, after we get the head of Hopefuls of the Man, after we have taken the head of Wike, now we will start from the church. Any pastor, any evangelist, as long as you have the location, you are not coming out right now. You don't need to even come out. We know all of you by name. Let me tell you. The Bible said, Mbaka, there one particular quotation that said, in the battle of the warriors, he said, garments shall be rolled in blood. Mbaka, revolution have started. It is because of revolution that God asked Saul, the prophet, he said, go to the Amalekites and Amalek. He said, destroy anything with that mercy. Mbaka, Mbaka, don't confuse people. Mbaka, igama, that, like as you have said, Mbaka, you say something that is living inside my skull. You let us to know that some of our young youths are like living in a refuge, living in a dead life in Europe. Mbaka, as you said it, so it is. Mbaka, we don't even know that you have been having contact with Elohim, but because of your greediness to feed your wives, that is why you are hiding the truth. Now the truth is coming out. Mbaka, let me tell you, no place of hiding. About four videos I did last time, I don't even remember anymore. Mbaka, there is a place the Bible says in the book of Revelation. It said that when the end time shall come, men and women will run to the mountain, the end time, and say, mountain, please, I want to hide myself. Mountain will tell you, I am also running to look for a place to hide myself. That is the scenario where we are right now. Because the kind of revolution you will see in Nigeria, you have never seen it before. This is not exercise protest, so where people will come and they will carry alcohol in their hand and they blow big drums for music. You will see people who are playing hip-hop. They are jumping around. When the police shoot one gun, everybody will go. Mbaka, that is not the revolution we're talking about. This revolution, it will come like when you drop a kerosene on top of a tuba of yam. Then, when you drop a kerosene, just a drop of kerosene on the tuba of yam, before you know it, it will saturate. Mbaka, you will hear it. It will start from your church because you are an evil man. People who are listening to me now, those who love Mbaka, we said, what are you talking? You are a nonsense man. They will give me a lot of names. But I don't care. We are in the revolution. Nigeria has fallen. Nigeria has fallen. They can go and bring China. They can go and bring everything. But the whole world is seeing all the sacrilege, the blood of the innocent that have been shed in that zoo called Nigeria. Mbaka, so you can talk. I don't even know that you have mouth to talk. Mbaka, you are not a man of God. You are a man of dog, G-O-D. If you don't know either. Do you know how deceptive Mbaka is? He knew what we are coming out with. He said, some people will say, Mbaka, you one time pray for Buhari, because you know what we are coming to say. First of all, he will go ahead of you because Satan also know the truth, but he cannot say the truth. Mbaka is not a man of God, though. Not only him. Another dangerous man in the history of Nigeria is this man you call Adeboye. A man that I loved before. Let me tell you before. We don't even know that it was our faith that have been working for these church people. And he will be in our world. Sometimes all these faith pastors, you see, they don't have faith. It was the faith to buy which you carry for your house and go to the church. Can they use you? Now, Roro. Another guy, when they try, they take your talent. Now, my eyes have opened. I am an evangelist, but they say, Kuka, Jua, Kekulos, Oka. Ian Poketa now, an activist, under the leadership of Mazen Nandakano, Biafra has come. Don't listen to Mbaka. Mbaka is a deception. Mbaka Bonyaro, Mbaka Bonyaro, Mbaka Bre, man of God. In your chamber, Mbaka Wunumaka, different places, Mbaka Kamara, Manakanaga, Ocho Mui. If you like, you pray for me, I will not die. BBC is still alive, Mbaka, nobody can kill me. Any day you hear that I die, it was my God that killed me. Okaba say, stop that, your adoration camp. Mbaka Bonyori. Mbaka Bonyori. If you are worshiping under Mbaka, let me tell you, and they are still clapping. I see a lot of people. Imagine it will be ways and check. All these people you see, Ugochi, all these people you see, our people have been hypnotized. You know, hypnotic are, you can find it everywhere in the church. Hypnotic. Mbaka, the church people, they practice it. Because, you know, as a Roman Catholic priest, one of the things they will teach you is how to hypnotize people. The Hindu uses, the Buddhist uses hypnotism. Even some of the drugs we take, it is a vibration of hypnotism that have been concocted in the drugs to hypnotize you. Konyana chifwebweze. Hypnotism is in different vibrations. If you don't know it now, Mbaka know how to practice it. Now, he hypnotized a lot of people in the adoration ground. Before he come, he have asked the devil, who is his father? What should I say? What am I going to say? Then he hypnotized people. When he hypnotized you, just like all these Pentecostal pastors are doing, then you forget what he said. You forgot what Mbaka said yesterday. Mbaka is the cause of the youths in Igbo land, in Nigeria, not having job by presenting Buhari, who is already dead. Now he's Connie, we're presenting to you Dave Umahi's family. I went to Igbo State. Fly over everywhere. Then Mbaka is telling us indirectly that Dave Umahi is the person that we're going to vote on 2023. Don't you see that Mbaka is a madman? Don't you see that Mbaka is a madman? Mbaka, let me tell you, when I grew up in Ochasu, where I come from, by then, the church has dismissed. Mbaka is not a churchman. Mbaka is a politician. Then he was planted onto Catholic Church in order to use this multiple congregation. Mbaka is not a man of God, though. Mbaka is a devil that has two tongues. Leago, serpent, his tongue is always true. And in the area of this reptile, Mbaka bo anaconda, he swallows everything. People say we should not talk about Mbaka, but let me tell us something. This man is not a man of God, believe me. Suddenly he changed. Suddenly he deceived Buhari. The same way, you see all these saboteurs that are talking about why one Nigeria Mazin Nanakan is crazy, IPOBs are this and that, those who conspire and kill Ikonso. Iko, my brother from Olu, let me tell us these things. All of you that conspire together with the same glutinous spirit that Mbaka has, all of you will pay. And all of you, when we mention your names, I say, not me, I am not there. Let me tell you, I am Agado Benala. I am Arande Buri Konsa. We know those who kill Konsa, but this revelation will meet you. We don't even need your family, your mother, or any other person, but what we need is your head. 2,000 head are needed. Mbaka, let me tell you, you also number one on this head we need. Okamani metra donation grand because Bawaso. I don't say anything yet, Mbaka. Let me tell you, revolution has started. And if you are an IPOB member, you know, I told you, Agibunda, it's better you just die now. And let me tell you something that God, Elohim, is telling me. When Mazen Nanakala Walida declared 2,000 head, oh, you can require your head of some of the IPOB coordinators. Then you will understand that behind the Gwemu VC, I gave you the note on Wema from Putawama. The highest broadcast our leader has ever done since I joined IPOB was this revolution uplifting. This revolution uplifting, it has started. Mbakama, he is educated. Mbakama, otherwise, he has gone to dictionary. He has gone to Google and asked Google, what is revolution? And Google have explained to Mbaka what is revolution. Who some other flavor pastors who are still, continuing their glutering, looking for money, one Nigeria, because they want to keep the church going. Pastor, let me tell you something. Chukwazeze, my man. You see this revolution? When we finish with the whole them, man, weekend will be found, and Dave Umahi and his general brother, all of these people are going down. You see Udele, he said, when you see Udele standing on the internet talking, see these guys as a dead criminal that have been waiting for execution. Let me tell you, as long as the dragon flag has gone up, Muhammad get delayed, then now he, oh God Almighty, let me tell you, you see this time around there, it has started, and we won't go back. And those of you who are planning on how to kill our leader Mazen Nanakala, I want to tell us something. With these 25 people watching me here right now, this is a very strong message. Share it to anybody. Nigeria will sink more fast. We destroy until eternity. Whatever time we hear that there is an attempt on Mazen Nanakala, our leader, Elohim will also never allow it to happen. It is anybody who have ever think or thought or remember to think or wanted to remember to think or preparing to think about the killing of Mazen Nanakano, that particular day, trailer when no get break, we heal till you die. Because this man is an institution of divine realm of heaven. It will not work. Or some of you who are planning it, you will succumb and die finally. Because let me tell you, Mazen Nanakano is a gift of God that came to the indigenous people of Biafra for 5,000 years ahead. If you don't know it now, he is above institution and nothing will happen to him. But I want to tell you, if there's any attempt, that family who tries to do it, you will die untimely. Oh God Almighty. You see, this year of Ikonso, a lot of things is about to happen. When I sit back and I look into the coming of Biafra, I see history printing themselves. Many heads will fall. Go back to Mazo Konkwo. Go back. I think I'm going to post that video, but I cannot share it. I wanted to share what I told us on the 31st of December 2020, that this year is a year of blood. People didn't understand it because I don't have private jets, because my name is not Chris Okafor, TB Joshua, and all this kind of, you know, affiliate for pastors who don't want to talk about this thing. Mbaka, how come money? It's better you begin to talk about your fellow pastors now, because this revolution, Mbaka, is not, this revolution is not coming only to your generation, Grando. No, don't even panic, not only you. It's coming from Catholic Church, Pentecostal Church, Orthodox Church. It's coming everywhere because we have Mbaka. So you can make peace like this. And you brought us Buhari and tell us and brainwash us and tell us that Buhari is a gift of God to you, Mbaka. People, we must be careful. Don't let anybody deceive you in the name of I'm a man of God. It's a lie. God has left Nigeria a long time ago. Do you know when God left? Oh, God Almighty. People, if you don't know that God has left Nigeria, God left Nigeria long time ago, long time, the day Agu Grossi was killed, the day Agu Grossi was murdered. I want you to follow this page, follow this particular message now. The day God left Nigeria was the day Agu Grossi was killed. Do you know when God finally left the church was the Ensa's protest? When Muhammad, Lai Muhammad, will come and lie that there's nobody killed in Ensa's protest. Nigerian flag have tainted blood. There is nothing you have to talk about in Nigeria. I want you to go back and listen to the message of my brother Lion Man. I don't know him. I have never spoken to Lion Man since I started this particular program. Do you know that night I listened to the message of Lion Man? What Lion Man was preaching was what God was ministering to me. Ask Lion Man, do I have thought to him? No. I listened to the message of Lion Man. I was thinking about how God will destroy Mbaka, who has given us Buhari. Mbaka said that God spoke to him that Mbaka, that Buhari is a gift. When Lion Man said this, it's like something triggered into me. I knelt down where I was and I began to meditate on the message of Lion Man. Do you know? I saw an arrow. It's like they shot me an arrow and I bent down. The arrow went off. Let me tell you something. You see the brother of Ikonso? We are talking about Ikonso, but there are also 10 people who were dead according to the report from our work. Let me tell you. Are you talking about that? There are also many of my brothers from Ochasi, where I come from, that have been kidnapped. But do you know why the life of Ikonso is more, I would say, more valuable? Not that the other ones are not valuable, don't misquote me, because Mazen Nandekano knows who Ikonso is, the holy cup of God. Ebo Ikonso. Let me tell the people of Imo State, the people of Imo State, God has backed out from you. God has rejected not only Nigeria, but Imo State. And when Mbaka was hitting, Mbaka knows that the truth, but the truth came late. Mbaka, we have closed the door of revolution. Mbaka, you will knock. Mbaka, you are example of what will happen to sinners the day Jesus will come. Mbaka, you are an evidence of that which happened when the Messiah delayed in the book of Mark or Malachi, when the Bible analyzed to us about the 5 veggies of, 10 veggies. Mbaka, you are one of them. Mbaka, so now you can talk the truth. I don't even know that Mbaka can say truth. Mbaka, you're a sinner. Mbaka, you are the most corniest person in the face of the world. And let me tell us something, people of God. Let me tell us this. When we talk about revolution, revolution is not only the indigenous people of Biafra that is on the ground. Revolution has to start first for we that are speaking and they are yelling on this Facebook. Mbaka Bu Esina. Mbaka is the main problem of the Igbo people. Mbaka, have you forsaken that there's one reverend pastor, a clergyman, a respected old man, I forgot his name, that came back and was begging Mbaka to come back? Mbaka, why didn't you return? Mbaka, you're a fearful man. Mbaka, let me tell you, the curtain has drawn. Mbaka, you can't escape this revolution. Open a Mbaka major this revolution simply means that all of us will go and apologize to the devil. Mbaka is a sinner. He's a brainwasher. He has a lot of tricks. Mbaka is a trick person. Not only that, he knows how to brainwash people. Let me tell you, when revolution comes, both saboteurs, fake politicians, both House of Representatives, those who sabotage, it doesn't matter, even if it is my mother, even if it is my brother, all of them must go down. That is how revolution, that is what revolution. Do you know why God get angry to Saul? The prophet Saul. God asked Saul to go and destroy the Amalekites. The reason why you must destroy saboteurs, destroy people in revolution, people like Mbaka, is so that, let me tell you, we from Mbaka, Mbaka with a leakage of brain. Onya abu baby saboteur. Put him on the side, but I want to tell him that we understand who he is, and I want to warn you, Mbaka, the same oil they pour on your head is the same oil they pour on my head. Mbaka, if you go inside your shrine and pray for me, thunder will fire you because you're not a man of God. Mbaka, you're a liar. Mbaka, you have never seen God before. Mbaka, you are only operating on the small, let me tell you from my house here, Mbaka, in a more prayer on the grace of God from Nanage, you don't know God. Mbaka, you're a sinner. Mbaka is a sinner. And all of us, those of you who are still going to adoration ground, is a lie. I remember when they did not go to stand, by that time we were in Onitsha. Every people were praising Edinog. I looked it. That time I was worshiping by, I became born again in Mbaka when I was 11 years old. Go and ask Pastor CY from Grace of God Mission in Onitsha. He will tell you now that Adabolo or Ekulobe Hall in those days. I was baptized in Ndemiri River. Let me tell you, I become the young ministers. Who led the young ministers in Aba? Mbaka, let me tell you, I know the scripture. You are a liar. Mbaka, you are a sinner. Mbaka, you were opportunity. Do you know why? Catholic Church boomed Mbaka and brought Mbaka on the first front. But Mbaka is a fake man of God who want to destroy the indigenous people of Biafra by all his bumbu yaya. But the curtain has drawn. Mbaka, we are into revolution. Close your church and begin to run away. Mbaka, because we are coming for your head. If you don't know it now, all hail Biafra. Thank you.
Of Nigeria. And also, we are going to look at the question we are bringing up today, the death of Ikonso. Is it going to bring finally the existence? Is it going to bring finally the existence of Nigeria? Is Ikonso's death going to change the tide of the struggle? Because we've seen that even the likes of Mbaka is beginning to condemn the death of Ikonso. A lot of people are coming out to condemn. Is Ikonso now going to make people start sympathizing with the cause, the genuine cause of IPOB and Biafra struggle? These are the questions we are bringing today. And I'll be opening the line if we have the time, because yesterday I promised to open the line, but I couldn't because of the time limitation and also the challenges I faced last night. But today, if we have the time, we might open the line if possible. If not, we shift it for some other time. But you know, our brother Mazi Solomon have not been live with us for some time due to his also first personal challenges. His job and taking care of his immediate family and stuff like that. So we want to welcome Mazi Solomon today on board. Mazi Solomon, I heard that your wife isn't feeling fine. I hope she's doing well now.
Mazi, Pat, that is not the reason why I haven't been online.
It's also important that Biafra understand the challenges you're facing as well.
That is by the way, there is nothing that the life of my people or the like of my people, everything Mazi Nnamdi Kanu said, we lay down everything to ensure that this struggle keep going. So yeah, I haven't been online because I've been overbooked, and I'm trying to ease myself, so I'm sorry about that. Every other thing comes secondary. There is no challenges we are facing that is not normal. or haven't been what we are used to. Thank you, everyone that are here today to listen to us. You are welcome, all the viewers, Biafran all over the world. You are welcome in this very platform. I welcome the lovers of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu and the haters of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. I tell you, they're always listening to us. If you watch all the whole media, you discover that they are preaching the message. They learn from us. And what we have been saying here is what now they are saying. So we are learning them voice. So I welcome all of you, the lovers of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu and haters of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. My name is Solomon Peter. I'm transmitting here from Australia. At my own end here, it is good night. At your end, it might be good morning, good afternoon, depend on your time zone. Thank you so much, Mazi Pat, for making me part of this very program. What our point of discussion, our topic of discussion this evening at my end is very, very simple. And every one of us has voice to this, for what we are here to discuss this very evening. Your comment is very, very important. Oh, pompon kamilija tujite. So it's very important. You keep making comment, keep saying your mind, the word are reading, the word are listening. Because nobody today can tell you that they are ignorant of what is happening in Nigeria. They are ignorant of what is happening in the Southeast. They are ignorant of what is happening in Biafran land. Nobody. Or what is happening at the Northeast, North Central. Or what is happening at Middle Belt. Or what is happening in Yoruba land. Nobody. The world. The only attention the world is paying today is what is happening in Nigeria. And they are hearing our voice, hearing your voice. So we cannot keep quiet anymore. They are hearing our voice. They are hearing your voice. And that's why you need to voice out. You need to voice out. You need to continue talking. Let nobody intimidate you. Let nobody intimidate you. Keep speaking. Keep saying something. A closed mouth is a closed destiny. And that is what it is. When they succeed in closing your mouth, your destiny is closed. But when your mouth is open and you can speak, then the world hears. The world hears. Remember, even the Bible says, and God sent forth his word. Remember that the word of God has been exalted above his name. So, and God said, I cannot send my word and it will return to me null and void without accomplishing the purpose which I have spoken. So you will know that you are created by the image of God. Your voice means something. Your voice means something. Your voice is the reason why some people who has claimed to turn blind eyes over the suffering of the Igbos and over the suffering of Biafran all over the world, over the suffering of the indigenous people of Nigeria, over the suffering of indigenous people that are trapped in Nigeria, your voice has been the reason why they are now opening up. They are now speaking. If you have kept quiet, many, they would have killed many. They would have enraged generation. They would have stopped everybody. But because you are talking, that is why we are not totally destroyed. That is why we are not totally stopped. So you need to continue to talk. You need to continue to speak out. It's very, very important. Make your contribution here. Now, what we are discussing today, will the death of Ikonso bring about the end of Nigeria now? Will the death of Ikonso bring the death, bring the end of Nigeria now? That's what we'll be discussing. Early this hour, when Mazi Pat called me, I say something to Mazi Pat. Sina ade ebu dike ebu. Okwagi ifunu dike. Ade ebu dike ebu. Ade ebu dike ebu. Ade ebu dike ebu. I will take example from what happened at Okuzu. There's a man in Okuzu called John Nebolisa, who become Odogu. Who become Odogu in Okuzu. Did they kill him? No. He even asks, as Odogu, he asks for Igwe. They give it to him. Because what Odogwu does is that Odogwu will come and will finish what him, the covenant he has with God, and he will go. You don't get them anyhow in generation. As soon as Mazi Nnamdi-Kanu is today, if you kill Mazi Nnamdi-Kanu, in the next 1-2 million generation of Igbos, they might not get a man. A man who should be as bold as Mazi Nnamdi-Kanu. Ade egbu odogwu egbu. Utodike putadike putodogwu gbue mbosi hi kemelo achobo odogwu. Odogwu dalo Imo State. Odogwu dalo Imo State. Ndi Imo State kwoshalaka tielo fa kwoshalaka tielo anumana aki ha kwoshalaka tielo anumana aki Odogwu dalo Imo State. We cannot stop speaking of him. We cannot stop talking about him. The like of Ikonso, in the next 1 million years or even billion years that Imo State will exist, they might not produce. I am here in Australia, my brother. Do you know how many rate of wasted, how many rate of human being that has disability in here in Australia? That I cannot say because I'm in public, but when it comes to the workforce of Australia, they are out of it. They are out of it. Do you know what it takes to get a sand man, a sand woman? Do you know that when you see, like when you come to Nigeria or when you come to Africa, people, they smoke Igbo, they smoke ganja in order to go and rob and commit crime. But people in the Western world, they will smoke Igbo, smoke ganja, only to inspire themselves to make sure that their nation is progressing. Ade Igbo Odogwu Egbu. Odogwu bi ihe na eme bu obia ome uwea. Ome ihe nya na chi ekutelo. Then on one natural death. And any obodo, any town, any city that saw Odogwu, anya fulugo, mulialugo, maka adafugo da. Adafugo da. Ndi nele Odogwu no obodo. People who sell Odogwu. I know why I'm missing my language this evening, because I need to deliver this message as natural as it can. As natural as it can. So I need to speak the language of heaven as Mazi Nnamdi-Kanu recommended. Ade Igbu Odogwu Egbu. Ihe na-eme bu afu Odogwu, ahapu Odogwu, omelo wea. Because any Odogwu obuna mela appear, any Odogwu obuna mela appear anywhere is for a purpose. Is for a purpose. And when that purpose is being defeated, the same nation or the same state, they might struggle in the next 1 million or billion years because they missed their appointed time. Ade Igbu Odogwu Egbu. And in the Imo State, no, men, anya had the open. Igbu Odogwu tolu, Odogwu plantele, Odogwu tolu na beha. Mazi Party, I want you to give me some time. Please don't rush me on this very program because I don't have time. But this message of heaven need to be delivered. In case of some people in your community, you are looking Odogwu. Ndi na-egbu Odogwu, people na-egbu Odogwu in their villages na-abu Akiri. Watch those people who point fingers in Odogwu, who point fingers to Odogwu in their villages. They are all Akaeli. The villages cannot depend on them if anything starts happening. Those men, those women, the villages cannot depend on them. Family cannot depend on them. Odogwu. It happened in Israel. Odogwu told Israel. They betray him. They sold their king ignorantly. Don't say I hurt you because you don't believe in Christ. If you don't like Bible, leave Bible. Go and read the Hebrew interpretation. Odogwu told in Israel. But they sell their king and destroy their king. And up to today, they are waiting for king. Odogwu. Ade ebu Odogwu ebu. Ana rapu Odogwu obia omelo uwea. Na. Because that Odogwu anwe follow is for a purpose. Now, Odogwu tolu nimo. Odogwu amulu nimo. Irudike na anyo manko. We cannot stop talking about him. Ikonso. Irudike na anyo manko. Tolu nimo. Ndindi imo kwesili iji wena abamba. Ndi imo kwesili. People that Imo state supposed to be proud of. And you will ask me why. The position Ikonso took to serve his people under voluntarily. If that position and that office where Ikonso choose to serve Imo state, if that position is as the same as the position of Senate or as the position of governor, do you think that Hope Uzodinma will accept to be a governor? I want you, Imo light, Imo people, for you to know, Imo people in Biafra land, I want you to know who loves you most. Killing Ikonso is regrettable. Odogwu telu Imo. And still, so many of you are still sleeping, are still sleeping. They have not wake up. They have not wake up from the sleep. Odogwu telling him, if the position in which Ikonso offered his life to serve the people of Imo State and defend them against the number fourth most dangerous terrorist in the world, if that position should be the position of a governor, or should be a position for somebody to be a governor or for somebody to be a senator, do you think that Hope Uzodinma can accept to be your governor? Even if they give it to him, he will run to America, he will run to SI. But Odogwu Ikonso, Ikonso in that position, deadly position, he gave his life to serve his people. In how many million years again do you think you can get Ikonso? In how many million years? Judge Wande Okuzu. When they saw John Nebolisa, the many people, hey, he's a thief, he's a criminal. Okuzu people said, Adebu Odogwu ebu. Adebu Odogwu ebu. Ibu Odogwu. Ibu Odogwu. Ihe Odogwu biali imenu. Unu welike ya dato oya in the next millions of years. In the next millions of years, Imo State, you have killed your hero. And what we are discussing this night, by killing your hero, will this now be the end of Nigeria? I want to t- tell you something you don't know. From the day that Ikunso was, from the day they murdered Ikunso till today, I want you to shake environments, shake what is happening, shake the way the mind of people started moving. The way the mind of people started moving, you will know that Ikunso Abrojos Ofu Akwehiri, Imo State, Imolo. Oburo Ofu Akwehiri, Imo State, Imolo. Odogu, Amolo Namba, Ikunso. Irudike na Anyum Manko. Imo State, Uno Nana Mili, Nchabao Nanya. Tell me the Senate you have from all your geopolitical zones. Tell me the representative you have in the House of Representatives. Tell me any politician you have in Imo State today that can serve Imo State in the position of Ikunso. If that is what Senate position is, if that is what governor is, tell me who can take it. Only Odogu, only somebody who is Odogu. If you are not understanding this language of heaven, ask your neighbor to interpret to you. The only Odogu people naturally, the position today that Ikunso took is only person who were naturally born. Who we are naturally born to inherit such thing or to take such position, take them. Politicians don't take them. If to serve Imo State is voluntarily, is not the money that they loot. It's not the money they loot. If to serve Imo State is voluntarily, nobody will like to be governor. Nobody. Nobody will like to defend Imo State. No governor will even want to. Nobody will even want to come and start out to defend Imo State. But Ikunso, Bodogu, Amulu Imo State, Irudike na Anyum Manko, he took that position to serve Imo State without any government money to bezel, to serve Imo State. Without any salary, he was serving voluntarily. Which governor, whose senate you are celebrating today, do you think he can do that for your sake or for the sake of your family? So on this note, we are telling Imo State, unonona mili nchaba unanya, and most of you are still sleeping, you haven't wake. I don't see the reason why Ikunso, an indigene of Imo Light, who devoted himself, sacrificed his life to save you against the most dangerous terrorist group in the world, not in Nigeria, the most dangerous, number four dangerous. Now, and the Imo State people are still sleeping in their house. No protests. No protests. You are still sleeping in your house.
Mazi, can we take?
You are not this, speaking out.
Yes, let's take this. Let's take this this clip very fast, and you return back to what you are saying, please. Just a moment.
Thank you.
How can the military, the police, the SS? How is it difficult for you to arrest one person? What if the person you kill is innocent of what is accused of? You kill the Ikunso, you are burning his body all over, as if to say you have done whatever. Go and kill poverty. Kill poverty for us. Kill unemployment for us. Kill insect. You kill the Ikunso, you are burning his body all over, as if to say you have done whatever. Go and keep poverty. Keep. You kill the concept. You are burning his body all over. As if to say you have done whatever. Go and keep poverty. Keep poverty for us. Keep unemployment for us.
So, Mazi Solomon, everybody is speaking out over the killing of Ikonso. This is Father Mbaka yesterday, very, very angry. And despite the fact that he had been against, what we've been doing, he had his own position. Let's take a look at the statement he released sometime in August 2018. Don't let Nnamdi Kanu mislead you. Father Mbaka breaks silence on Biafra, IPOB crisis. The influential cleric said, nobody should deceive you, saying that Igbos are hated. That's how we Igbos believe nonsense. The poor masses are told to agitate for Biafra. There is nothing wrong in Biafra, but those that say they want Biafra now or never should come out. Let us see the cream of the Igbos, then we all will push for Biafra. Let the cream de la Igbo among the Igbos be at the forefront, while the poor masses that loiter the street in the name of Biafra will support from behind. The right thing is for parents to protect their children from danger. I am not against Biafra, but let the Igbo elites, political elites, the Obas of Anambra, the P2B, the Ekweme, the Ekweremado, the Nnamani, Sullivan, Chime, Anyim Payosa, Anyim, Ayim, Baka, ETC should be the ones pushing for Biafra, not our children, who get killed on the street every day. Where are the Igbo political elites? They are in the hiding in Abuja and overseas. They have sent these children to push for Biafra and they have gone in hiding. That is not leadership. A leader should be in front to take bullets for his followers, just as Christ willingly gave his life for his followers. A leader is not one who sits and sacrifices the poor for his ambition. This was a program he did on the 4th of August 2018, and about 3 years down the line, the death of Ikonso have change the narrative. Mazi Solomon.
That is just the point. Now, Mazi Pat, why I agreed to sit in this very program this evening is because most of Imolite did not know what they lose. Some of them, they haven't come to realization of what they lose. And if the Imo fail to understand what they lose by the killing of Ikonso, those Odogu that are in Enugu State have not recognized their Odogu today. Some are still plotting against their Odogu. Some, they are still plotting against the Odogu. All their Koyeri, Efulefu. All the flavor. You see them when that time John Nebolisa was in Okuzu. Hey, is Onyoshi, is Oyama, is there this, is there that? But John Nebolisa remains the only son of a soil that bring the president of Nigeria to sleep in their village. The president of Nigeria that are serving to sleep in their village. Babangida slept in Okuzu while serving. But how many of them today can do it? Odogu bi mu odogu namba. Mo neme ma mo neme njo. Even Maodogu, Manjodogu is for the benefit of where that Odogu was planted. Ikonso is Odogu. And the why you will know that Ikonso is Odogu is because The death of Ikonso will bring the end of Nigeria. All these things that you are struggling all this way, but the record and history can never again in this life ignored that Imo State people, Nona Mili Nchabahanya, these terrorists that are terrorizing your city, your community, that government we are not able to defeat, Fuli Ikonso, Buffalo, they saw Ikonso and they disappeared. Ikonso commanded the troop that give the number fourth in the world, the most dangerous terrorist. They saw Ikonso and they took flight. They ran away from Imo State. The terrorists that the government of Imo, Hope Uzodinma, was not able to dare, they are all afraid. The terrorists that Nigeria as a sitting government, we are not able to dare, they are all afraid. Their soldiers are afraid. Their police are afraid. Ikonso took the battle to them. Oh, Ije Malodogun. Ikonso stood for what you can know Odogu for, but you don't have him today. History can never forgive people who are Imolite, who are washing, and then the enemy sneak in your community and take the life of Odogu. Take the life of Odogu. People call in Radio Biafra. They will praise Uche Mofor. Thank you for the work you are doing for us. Thank you. But Uche Mofor has never gone to any fierce protests. There was no protest where the bullet is raining, where the tear gas is raining. You have never seen Uche Mofor in that front. His eyes has never seen what Mazen Nnamdi Kanu have seen. So many people that are saying today, bring it, come back and lead in the front. You saw Mazen Nnamdi Kanu when he was going to Abakeleke. When Dave Umahi say he will not come, he sent his soldiers. On his way to Abakeleke, they stopped him. He did not stay in the car for people to protect him. He came down. He came down and lead from the front. And the lead from the front, the soldiers are armed. They are armed and they are sent to kill. But Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, Ibubagu Nechago, he came and lead on the front. If they have seen what he saw, their heart would have caught. Thank you. They are only sitting in the comfort of their room. Odogu, Imo State. Odogu, Ikonso, not in the front. People that should die are still breathing. People that are useless for Imo State are still breathing. Begging food, looking for crumbs that fall from politician table. But they conspired the way the people of Israel conspired to take away their king. People who are supposed to be in the grave are still walking around. People who are useless, who has bezzled the money of the Imolite, people who has reduced the people of Imolite to nothing, who has published Imolite. People who has published you, who has ate your money, who has made your condition as it was as it is, they are still alive, walking freely. No wonder the book of Proverbs said, these are the evil that we saw on earth, that servants are riding on horses, slaves are riding on horses, kings and princes are walking barefooted. I'm from Anambra State. I cannot see a person that is like Ikunso, and I will not protect him. In short, there will be no Dogu like Ikunso in Anambra State. That we will not stand and protect and defend at all costs. There is none, because we know the importantness of Odogu. Hey, Ghana Anam Gapatu Odogu Anamaka. What he called, so go to Anam. Jua, who is a Bernard Odogu Roma? Jua, who is this guy Odogu Miata? This same job when thief were everywhere terrorizing all those areas. What make Bernard Odogu and what make Odogu Miata is the same way of coming, standing in the gap to fight against the criminals that are eating up their communities. They become Odogu. Miata people, they protect them. Oroma, they protect their Odogu. Because they are very important species. It's hard to see such people. They are not coward. They are not people like they will hear the sound of gun. They are not like such people. Fulani are shooting the worst terrorists. He consulted his, he commanded his troop. He consulted Bodogu. Will the death of Ikunso bring the end of Nigeria? This discussion include you. This discussion, you need to comment. Will his death bring the end of Nigeria? That is what we are discussing now. Because Odogu cannot die for nothing. No. He doesn't die for nothing. Though Imo Light did not recognize their Odogu, they have not wake up from their sleep. They have not recognized that Nahib Godoguha. If Imo State people recognize Nahib Godoguha, who puts on the necessary to again the Imo State? Who puts on the ma umuihe again or to up an Imo State? Maburu nandi Imo Light have discovered Nahib Godoguha. Odogu bi ihe mba ji adi ebube. Odogu bi ihe gaga point ya mba kasi ge eje pan eba an Odogu no kwa dia. Don't go there. Odogu no dia. Odogu aburo ni Diego. Odogu bu mpologu oji. Oko sisi. If they realize all the politicians who conspired, including traditional rulers, who conspired to see the death of Odogu in Imo State, none of them should be living in Imo State today. None of them. Because they are there. They did not dare the Fulanis. They did not dare the terrorists that Ikunso dared. This is not Facebook talk. He was down on the ground. Everything happened in his own eyes. He saw the anger of the Fulanis. He saw the sham of the Fulanis. He saw the wickedness of the Fulanis to overtake your village, destroy your crops, rape your mother and your sister. He saw it and he put his head He put his head. Is not one of you that run away when you hear shaka bom. Ebwento. He faced Fulanis who are carrying machine guns. Who has defeated every Nigerian effort. They kill whosoever they want to kill, destroy any farm they want to destroy. People are, even in Nigeria, people start paying Fulanis just to visit, to pass and see their farm. They will tell you how much you will pay. Fulani, they will enter your farm, command their cow, eating your farm crops. Nothing, nobody says anything. But Odogu, Amunimo State, Tinyelisi, against Oburondibu Ebwento, Afanya, oh! No, Ndibu machine gun. Ndibu machine gun. He has seen the sample they keep here and there. But Otinyisi, he commanded the army of the Lord. And we can never allow anybody to spit on the dead body of this Odogu. In this my generation, Odogu anyamu na abu afro. And we can never allow anybody that belongs to any other community of Igbos or Biafran land to make himself available to join hand to kill the Odogu. Malaya today, know it today, Adebu Odogu Ebu. Oklikli kana abu kwese, manade alienu. When you see Odogu in your community, allow him. Kome ihe chineke, kolu olu chineke zilie, nguongu shie. Because when you miss him in 1 million years, it might take you 1 million years to miss him. Definitely. It might take you 1 million years. Etu akesi amuhada. Ada amuhada. Unubwe nandekanu today. In 1 trillion years of Igbo land, unenwe ike, inwetekwa. Person they can and they can. That's why we swear to protect him, because we know the word. Another point: Samson died in Israel. They failed to protect him. He died. How long does it take them again to have somebody like Samson? One man riot. We are not talking of, you can get people who can come and make noise one time or the other. But do you see one man riot? One man that will face the Philistines and the face two nations at once, and your soldier will be at peace, and your town and city will be at peace. One man will face nations. Mbe Habulu Samson, the time they killed Samson, did they get somebody like him again? When they killed Samson, they allow themselves for Samson to be killed. When that Samson died, did they get Samson? One man that we meet will be going on his way, meet lion and tear it with bare hand, put hand in the mouth, tear it. He faced nation. He went outside, they lock him on the gate. He took the gate, put on his shoulder. Odogu. Will the death of Ikonso bring the end of Nigeria? That is what we are discussing. Has Imo State recognized that Odogwu has left them. You know, when these people are not Odogwu, people like around them, their wife, their community, they always see them as common. Imagine even when Jesus came to Israel, they also see him as common, as common. But is he common? They conspired and they killed him. And up to today, they have not recovered from that action. You see what happened. If not for the covenant that God kept for Israel, there will be nothing like Israel today. But God said, okay, I will have a period of time. I will show them pepper. I will scatter them all over the world. They will be persecuted. It is by the word of God that the Israelites were killed like fowls all over the world. Because their king come to them to save them. They conspired and killed their king. And they scattered all over the world, being persecuted. You don't know what it takes when you miss your king. When you miss Odogwu in your village, you don't know what it takes. This might be 1 million years suffering of generation when they miss their king. Imo State need to realize it. And when they realize it, right now, tomorrow morning, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu say Douglas Street and all the house and government house, Amausa in general, no place again like Douglas, no place again like Amausa. They are Ikonso Street. They are Ikonso House. If you know you have lost your hero at this very point, by tomorrow morning, carry paint, carry poster, everywhere in that very street, write Ikonso. Anywhere you can see yourself to write, write Ikonso Street. And hero has been killed by Nigerian police and Nigerian army. A national hero, an hero appointed by God, a deliverer, has been killed. And will this be the end of Nigeria? Join this discussion. Make your comment. Because if Nigeria remained the same, if Nigeria remain the same, you will know that the hero have not died. That is not an hero that they kill. They have killed an hero. And Nigeria cannot remain the same. And I'm calling all Imolite to recognize that people sneak into their town and into their village and take the life of their hero out. And take the life of their hero out. If you don't know, there is people in your community whose, for their sake, God will prosper your community. There is people now that for their sake, God will bless your community. God will bless your state. If you kill such people, you will bring cost upon your state. You will bring cost upon your community. Ikonso is an hero. What I am being now, because the spirit of hero, when the spirit of hero are being humiliated, the way Imolite allow Nigerian army to humiliate the spirit of an hero. If you don't appease him, the punishment will be terrible. If you don't appease the man that is full of life and the spirit, if you don't appease him, oh, pialo odibo mo pialo odibo pialo mu fugi. So that is why we are calling your attention to this. Imolite, arise. Arise. Any other what do you call them? Any other indigenous people, protect your Odogwu, protect your hero, protect your hero. Protect your hero. Because you might not know what the hero is protecting you from until that hero is being uprooted in your community. You might not like the wear of his dress, his face, or this, but they are specially created by God. And you might not know their job until they are being uprooted. That is my message. Imoraiti will rise.
Mazi, let's listen to another message concerning Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. People who at some point despise him are now beginning to recognize that he's a hero, just like you said.
It may interest you to know that up to today, I don't know who is Nnamdi Kanu. I have never seen him face to face. Look at my hand on the altar again. But I want to tell you something. Wherever he is, may God bless him. Because if somebody has risen up to shout that his children, his brothers are suffering, is it a crime? May the Lord bless his courage. What is happening is tear-shedding, is heart-rending, is nerve-breaking, is mind-blowing. Can our security agents and leaders account for us how many children, how many Nigerians have died under 1 week, under 1 month? Students being kidnapped from the universities. And there is a leadership. No, either they are involved in it, or they should stop it, or what is happening will stop them. So Buhari and the Hope and Co. and those who want to fight, before you begin to fight, remember there was a time God asked me to support you people. Now God asked me to withdraw and prophesy against you.
Yeah, so Mazi, so welcome.
Mazi Kangwagi. Now, we have been screaming for you to know. You don't know. That's why I'm telling you. The death of Ikonso has changed the mind of Mbaka. And the death of Ikonso is going to change the mind of so many people that are holding you down over the years. That's why I said Imo State, they don't know what they lost. Hi! Jesus. They don't know. Imo State don't know what they lost. They are still one ESN commander is not like one ESN commander. Yeah, this is not Facebook live video on the comfort of your zone after eating ofo egusi. Those of them na choka ade alhamo onugu omo ogiri no fe ogiri igariti ekwu ogiri no fa after eating it. This is not the case. Ihabodogu onwu Ikonso have changed the mind of Mbaka over the agitation. Onwu Ikonso has make Mbaka to give up for Nigeria, give up for Buhari, give up Hope Uzodinma. and you are still an Imolite. Mbaka is from Enugu State. And you are an Imo person. After losing you, Odoku, you are still sleeping. You are still awaking. You are still sleeping.
Do you know the thousands of lives, Ikonso have saved in Imo State from the hands of Fulani herdsmen, from, you know, can you paint the picture of the thousands of lives, people that, even the people who conspired against him today are alive because he was there for them. Some of the people that conspired against him are alive against him because he saved their own lives.
People who conspired against Ikonso, Odogwu Amulu Nimo, Irudike Nanyo Manko, people who conspired against him cannot even help their family. People who conspired against him, you had in Uzu One. I send you the video at Enugu State where Fulani people are shooting the barrel, not AK-47, no, the barrel and the knockout. Umuibu na aboso. Na ben na ha, oso na achuha. Madisu gwausa. Just imagine, nyabu godilo nyibo. Let it be an Igbo man that is shooting in Sabongeli, Kano. Let Igbo man shoot up, even knock out. Or harass the Hausa people in Sabongeli, Kano. Only will be on or email video. Osama Bow. These are the kind of people that betray Odogwu Amulu Nimo State. These are the kind of people. Ndika no po ha banana bed, ha tebenezo, ikana maha pali pali, arwana maha pali pali, ubiana kotoha. These are the people that betrayed him. And what can they offer to Imo State? What can they offer to Imo State, to the people of to the indigenous people of Imo State? What can these men and women offer? Nothing. They will watch you die. They will watch you. They will carry AK-47 shooting in your community, and you will be running for a place to hide. You know, Ogun State today, they chase the people of that community down to another country, taking refuge. They left their house. In Benue, they chase them out from their community and the house, and they are living somewhere in where they are taking refuge. They also go there to attack them. And the such cowards will be watching these things, it will be happening to their people. They will do nothing. But not as the like of Ikonso. Ikonso cannot take that rubbish from Fulani herdsmen. And you are an Imolite. Inoduna mili nchobaganya. Ikonso cannot take that nonsense that a Fulani man stood in the midst, in the community, in the township of Igbo land, shooting. And Igbo people are running away. Ikonso cannot take that rubbish. Uzodinma can take that rubbish. The governor of Enugu State can take that rubbish because they are not there for you.
Man, the day the people were massacred in Ozo One, the only thing that Ugwanyi was able to offer the people of Ozo One was shedding tears in public. He was crying like a little child. Ugwanyi was crying like a baby. He was crying like a baby in public. That was the only thing he could offer. And the next thing is to tell people to go into fasting and prayer. This is Ugwanyi crying in Ozo One, where his people were murdered. He could not build and raise a vigilante. He could not organize men and say this thing will never happen again. This is picture of Ugwanyi crying and telling people to go into fasting and prayer. These are the kind of men that betrayed Ikonso today. These are the bunch of cowards that betrayed the Odogwu that we see today. Mazi Solomon, go ahead.
That is true. These people, can they come out in the night when they plan? Even if you call them in the night, all these people standing here, when you take call them in the night, that the Fulanis are in your village, they are rampaging in your village, can they put head, these people? But they will claim they love you. They will claim with their mouth, hey, we are your governor. Can they come out? No. But not like the like of Ikunso. In the midnight, Ikunso rose up. In the day, he rose up. Say, Odogwu like him cannot be here. A Fulani man will be carrying AK-47. No Odogwu. Irudike na anyu manko. Irudike na anyu manko. Everybody might be in the size of this man as he stand the physical now. But it's not everybody that carry the heart that this man carry. Is a special species. Oh my God. Is a special breed. From where you uprooted this Odogwu in 1 million years, you might not get another one. In where this Odogwu is. That is why when people in our olden days, you see the wisdom of our fathers, when people come, they will first come and ask, who is this person? Because they want to be aware of you. If you are aware of who this, if Imo State are aware of this, who is this Ikonso, they would have not make any attempt. They would have protected him with their life. You see people, they are dying for Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. You think they are stupid. Today, the bullet, if you say that any bullet will kill Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, somebody will come out willingly and take that bullet. Do you know why? Because they know that it is not just like this man is in Nnamdi Kanu, but is a special breed. Is a gift to generation. When you miss this very gift, you can never have the like in 1 million years. You can never. Nigeria, you are looking at today. As in a chuku kela ko libo makoga adelea, uwe bulu mili webagolenu. God, who knows that your situation will be like this in Nigeria today, that is why he sent this Odogwu to be in your midst. That it is your responsibility to protect them. It is your responsibility to protect them. It is your responsibility to guide around them, to make sure that your enemy did not sneak in and take people like this from your community. Because most, I know why I'm delivering this message. Because Ozi Obiligwe Zilim Buihe Nezi. Because so many people are still careless about the special breed that God has sent to them. The eyes of Mbaka is open now in the realm of the spirit. He now understood that there is special breed. Everybody cannot be the prophet Elijah. Everybody cannot be the prophet Elisha. They are special breed, the chosen one. Everybody cannot be David. If you miss the David of your generation, you are gone. Goliath, the sons of Goliath and daughters of Goliath, they will grow and overrun your generation. That is pure truth. You must know the histories are there, relate to history. That is why when we are little, our mothers and our fathers because you need, that is how to develop human being. Check the history and then relate the history, allow the history to interpret to you the present. Allow the history, even if it is that na amana how to call the akoko say mbe ago or this thing, but that story they are telling you, it is a pure education. That when what they are telling you about is not just animal, because they are just interpreting characters to you, relating history, interpreting character on which they wanted you to learn from it, a part of education that you need to carry along. That is why when somebody is telling lie and the corny, they will call you tortoise. What makes you feel like tortoise is corny? But our people, they educated you so that you will understand the you will understand the character of corniness and the how to deal with it. That is the education of our forefathers. That's why I always refer you to the history in the Bible, to the word of God in the Bible. They are the history that you will always relate to. If you miss your helper, you will suffer. Imo State, Odogu has been operated in Imo State. Will this mark the end of Nigeria? There we go. There we go. Because we need to watch the event. Now, the governor of Imo State is being polarized in Abuja. He's not coming into Abuja. Because Odogu Polunamba. Abroad is not because of what is happening. And if the spirit of Odogu is not being appeased, I am telling you, the vengeance will be very high. The vengeance, because that Obala Odogu Polone Basalana is nothing something to joke about. I am telling you, the world is listening to us. You are listening to us. Imolite are listening to us. Even later, people are going to refer and listen to this very video. Ihe Melinimo, Odogu Dalo. Will this be the end of Nigeria? There we go. Because so many hearts are turning right now. So many hearts are turning right now. And this is how you will know. Odogu Dalo Namba. Odogu Dalo Namba, at the end of the day, you will do everything you will do. That all that the spirit of Ikonso is requesting today, as I'm speaking to you, is the fall of Nigeria. So if you yourself knows that you have lost this Overi Odogu, you need to make sure that Nigeria, that all the people that trapped in Nigeria is being set free, because this is what Ikonso vowed for. This is the oath that Ikonso took. And if we didn't achieve it, the spirit of Ikonso, you might say, many people have been killed in Nigeria, but that is not how Odogu goes. That is not how they go. If we did not achieve it, if we did not show Ikonso that this Nigeria that killed him is not good for human being to habit it, if we did not show Ikonso that this Nigeria that killed him will cease to exist, you know that there will be restlessness in our communities, in our societies, and people will be asking, where is this poverty coming from? Where is it coming from? Where is it coming from? All this bad luck, all this backwardness, all this, you will be asking all these questions. This is how the spirit of Odogwu take revenge. Will this be the end of Nigeria?
The number is on the screen for those who we are going to end very soon. Mazi, I know your time is limited, but we'll put the number on the screen just to take one or two calls. For those who want to call in, the number is +39388177965. Call in and make your contribution. With the death of Ikonson, have Nigeria finally come to an end? The existence of Nigeria? Because at the end of the day, it is no longer going to be business as usual. Mazi Solomon.
That is true. That is true. What is your comment? What is your comment? You need to make your comment. Mazi Pat, can you help me read out some of the comment? Because yeah, people need to know that their voice.
We have series of comments. We have series. We have hundreds of comment. Mazi, our lawyer NZG said, Mazi Solo, please gather your spirit together. I can feel your pain, and we will do so. We will do. Ikonso is our blood, and we will remember him forever. Onyeka Darasin said, may the death of Ikonso bring us freedom and independence in the name of Jesus. Solomon Peter, speak, God bless you. Yeah, so we have series of okay, Baram Samson said, we will visit all governors and all the politicians. Chigozie Ezeagu said, Fulani people are not killing their own hero, but Igbos are killing their own. Very sad. Mazi, do you know that up till now, some people are still saying that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is in foreign land, enjoying with his family, while he's commanding people to fight? There is somebody that dropped that comment, but what I did was, because you know, when you meet senseless people, sometimes you just delete their comment and block them because they are not supposed to be part of what we are doing.
Mazi, if you have blocked that guy now, will he be able to hear what?
He can hear, but he can no longer comment.
Okay, yes. Okay. Listen very, very well as a regard to Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. A like of Ikonso is the reason why Mazi Nnamdi Kanu cannot pack down. Listen.
Mazi Solomon, hold on. Do you know that what happened to Ikonso was what they wanted to do to Mazi Nnamdi Kanu with Operation Python Dance? Kill him, parade his dead body to intimidate Ndibo and to shame Ndibo. But by the grace of God, he was able to escape that assassination attempt. What happened to Ikonso now was what they planned to do to our leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. And the enemy would have been rejoicing while we'll be in pain. And we are the ones that opened the door for the enemy to come in, by the way. Mazi, go ahead.
And that is why, if anybody recognized that Ikonso is a gift of God to Imo land and to Imo light, if you recognize it, you will never give anybody that represents Nigeria any breathing space in Imo land. They did not deserve to exist. Nobody that represents the present government of Buhari that warrant to exist. Nobody that talk good of them. Nobody that promote them. If you cannot be a voice to the voiceless, what is your need? If you all that you come on this earth, Kebulo Timpu, to the big men, to people who publish your people, kill your people, destroy your people, eat their money, and they make themselves comfortable elsewhere. If what you come to this earth to do is to be singing the praises of such people, then you a useless man, you a useless woman, Igbo slave. You must be voice to the voiceless. Because if you claim you are religious on that day, God will not ask you and said, I don't know you. Because money of the state. But he will say, I don't know you. Because when I'm sick, he will refer to you those who the government have refused to build health facility for. Those that the government have refused to clothe, that are going naked because there is no job, because there is poverty. He will refer you to those people. He said, go, I don't know you. He will refer you to people who our government has published that does not have food in their house on their table this very night. He will say, I was hungry. You refused to buy me food. Refused to give me food. He will never recommend, say, I am there because I am a big man and you refuse to sing my praises. You are a useless man if you claim that all you come to do on this very earth is to sing the praises of people who killed innocent souls. If you refuse to be their voice, you did not want to exist. If you refuse to be the voice of the voiceless at this moment, then you did not want to exist. You must know that. That is very, very important. Ikonso is the voice of the voiceless. He took the place of the poor. He took the battle of the poor, the battle of the helpless, defenseless people. He put his life online that they may live, that they may be proud of themselves, that they may feel like no dogu no number. That is the like of Ikonso. And let me tell you about Mazin Nnamdi Kanu. You don't know what you have. Oh my God. When Mazin Nnamdi Kanu stand in the Radio Biafra and he will be telling you, and you will see him confidently speaking out, it's not because of himself, but it's because of the people, the like of Ikonso. If Mazin Nnamdi Kanu Nemen Ganga na Radio Biafra is because of the like of Ikonso. So most of you who are playing with our heroes, you don't know the game. Ade ebu odogu ebu odogu na abia emu uwea omechu uwea ona mbabulo odogu na atafufu mba mba. The tribe that killed their heroes suffer. That's all you need to know. Mazin Nnamdi Kanu have many times lived the war.
Mazin, can I take you go do clip of our Odogu just for like 2 minutes so that people will understand? When you call a man Odogu, even in his voice, you feel it. Let's take this clip so that people will understand what we are talking about. Nobody to honor. Mazin Nnamdi Kanu promised that he's going to bring down all the roadblocks in the eastern region. And today, those roadblocks are down. Mazin, Obudi to honor. Odogu have a guy name.
To defend our land against the excesses and ravages of Fulani terrorism and the hegemonic tendencies of the Sokoto Caliphate. For years, our mothers have not been able to go to the farms. Our daughters are being raped and cut into pieces. Everybody is aware of what transpired at Nimbo, at Ozowani, what is happening right now in Delta, what is also happening in Ebonyi State and also in parts of Abia. We cannot allow it to continue.
Mazin, hold on. Can you compare this man speaking? Can you compare him to this man crying here? Mazin Solomon, can you compare a man speaking to this man crying? Mazin Solomon, how is this man crying supposed to be the producer of this man speaking?
Ejibo agwe onyocha. Ejibo agwe onyocha. But do you know that this man that is crying now is the person that so many slaves regard as hero than the original hero? Than the original hero.
It is Uguay of Enugu, the governor of Enugu, so that people will not be asking because he covered his face in tears. Let me call his name so that if you don't know, this is the governor of Enugu State, Ifeanyi Ugwuanyi, crying when Nimbo was attacked. Mazi Solomon. And this is the reaction of the men Odogu when Nimbo, talking about the same Nimbo, listen.
To defend our land against the excesses and ravages of foreign terrorism and the hegemonic tendencies of the Sokoto Caliphate. For years, our mothers have not been able to go to the farms. Our daughters are being raped and cut into pieces. Everybody is aware of what transpired at Nimbo, at Ozowani, what is happening right now in Delta, what is also happening in Ebonyi State, and also in parts of Abia. We cannot allow it to continue. We have cowards and spineless, lily-livered idiots as governors. They have given over our land to the Janjaweed to occupy.
See the governor here that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is talking about. Lily-livered, Okoko. Rather than pick up the fight for his people, he bent his face in shame and crying crocodile tears. Mazi Solomon. Our people need to wake up.
Hi. Bwedike, bwedike. Mbosi hi edike geme. Mbosi hi ke geme. Achoba dike. If this governor today, if they come to take him, if they come today to bring him down, who is he going to call? Who are those people that when they come out, when they come out, you will know that you have people. Where are they? They are the consort that you kill. They are the consort that you kill. Odogwe Jejemba, Irudike na Anyum Manko, Anibu. Kerebu Nuno, Nde Madwele Bata, from nowhere. Wezunarunu, Iye Jejemba. Why shouldn't he cry? Because they kill people. Who will make them boldly? Who will make them to stand tall among their enemy? They kill them. They destroy them. Do you think that today, this muscle that you have in your body, if this muscle is taken out of your body, do you think your body will stand?
Evangelism. If you want to come to your meeting, because at the end,
Mazi, are you sending any message? Do you think that if this muscle that you can use to stand, use to lie with woman, use to do everything you do, if this muscle is being taken out of your body, imalno afifede? That is how Odogu is. Your community, your city, your state is example of your body. Is example of your body. Look at how body is structured. No, because of the sensitiveness of Anya. So the muscles, you see how the muscles are carrying your body. That is how your community is. That is how Odogu is in your community. Odogu, they are the muscle. They are the muscle. They are the muscles in your community. They are the muscles in your state. They are the muscles. They are the thing that the leaders of communities and the leaders of the states, even all the leaders, they are the people that when you see in the community, you will turn a blind eye. You don't take straight eyes to look at those people. Because if things turn around, who are you going to call? Who? This police that has pot belly, that if you come where the police people are eating, people who love food like that, how do you think that they can put head and defend you against machine gun? If you see where the soldiers are eating, they are eating like easy. Turkey, chicken, people who love life like that, how could such people protect you? How can you call on such people? But look at Odogwu Unuji Ejemba, Odogwu Amuru Namba, Unuga ne protect, na kedi unu chol, kedi unu neli, kedi ene edepe, because mbosi hi kegeme, ipoputo Odogwu ge, osaba, everywhere. Or everywhere we know ni mwelo Odogwu.
The typical example is the late Muhammad Buhari, because the Fulani understand how fierce Buhari is, that even when he died, they covered him and brought his look-alike to represent them, because they know that with him, Harry Jemba, Mazi Asimasi.
Yes. That is exactly Odogwu. If ndi Odogwu gine protect her, because ndi Odogwu be the reason why people are afraid of your place. Afraid of your place. Because how am Odogwu well? How am Odogwu gine protect her? Gine protect her. Nobody. It's not everybody today. Who and who? Where can you select people who has the kind of mind that we also have, the kind of strong mind,
Mazi,
the kind of mind
today, Mazi? Today, the Fulanis have used a look-alike of Buhari to subjugate everybody in Nigeria. Look-alike, fake Buhari. They even presented a fake Buhari. They spent money. They do surgery. They did everything because they needed somebody in that look alike to be able to do what they are doing today with herdsmen, terrorizing people, killing people, taking over people's land. They need somebody with look alike of Buhari. Mazi.
Mazi, that is it. Yeah. In 2 minutes, I will be rounding up. But my last word here, because I wanted people to join into this very conversation, and they have done wonderfully well by raising their comment. Now we are looking, should the death of Ikonso bring the end of Nigeria? This discussion continue, because right from the day that Ikonso breathed last, Nigeria have never remained the same, and Nigeria can never remain the same. And we are seeing, since the death of Ikonso, we are seeing Nigeria going down in haste, and we see Biafra resurrecting. And I'm telling you, join in this very discussion, the killing and the death of Ikonso, will it bring the end of Nigeria? So you will join us next time. And listen, please, my brethren, what I'm trying to say and achieve with this very program and things we have said is that so many of you are neglecting the Odogwus that God has sent in times like this. Remember, when you read the book of Esther, there is something Esther told her uncle. When her uncle was telling her about what is going to befell her people, the Esther said, maybe it's for this purpose I am born. Maybe it's for this reason I was here. This Odogwu, all this Odogwu around you are trying to betray. It might be for the reason for what Nigeria has become, that God sent those angels, that God sent those saints, that God sent those people because of time like this. But you who doesn't value what you have, you will keep the train. Keep the train. Abachoso, Aguamayo. I will see you once again. Mazi Pat wishes to bring me back into this
thank
very program.
Very
before
thank
then.
You for that passionate analysis. Thank you very much. Mazi Solomon, we appreciate you. And people have been trying to call in. I don't know what the problem is. The network continues to interrupt. I've tried to pick some calls, but they are not going through. And I'm very, very happy that you've been able to see from a more broader perspective how the people sold their own for whatsoever reason. But one thing we can assure you and guarantee is that IPOB intelligence is on the ground to fish out those who carried this betrayal act against a commander of the Eastern Security Network. So if you know your hand is involved, do not sleep. If your hand is involved in the betrayal and the death of Ikonso, do not sleep, because you are going to pay the price of betrayal. I'm not saying it for the sake of saying it, but I'm saying it because that is what it's going to be. So anybody who is involved in the death of Ikonso, prepare, because your own day is coming, day of judgment, sooner than you expect. Each and every one of you involved have put a price tag on yourselves. And the leader of IPOB, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, have made the promise that he is going to bring justice and vengeance along for the purpose in which Ikonso was betrayed and killed by his own community, by the people in his own village, possibly by his own Igwe and the chiefs and the kings and all the people there. It's already past midnight, heading to 1 a.m. here. Yesterday, I was supposed to now, yesterday, that was day before yesterday, on the 27th, I was supposed to host a program with a brother who escaped Fulani herdsmen between Enugu and Anambra. He was kidnapped, and he promised to come to this program. So we are expecting him anytime. He's ready to join us to tell us his story, how he survived, and how much he paid to be able to free himself from the dungeon. And in his story to me, he said that all the Eastern governors knows about the Fulani herdsmen operation in the Eastern region. The governor of Enugu knows, the governor of Anambra knows, all the Eastern governors knows about the kidnapping of Fulani herdsmen, and they have just been pretending as if they did not know. All the politicians knows about it. But they've been pretending. They put the life of our people on the line for so long, for a very, very long time. And I hope that when the brother comes around, he will be able to tell the story, because the problem is that we, the Igbos, do not start running from the rain when it's still early. We wait until the rain have, you know, destroyed us before we accept that it's even raining. It is important that he comes to our program to also narrate his story for those who believe that it will never get to them. Because he never believed that it will never get to him. He didn't believe that he will ever be kidnapped in his father's land. And today he's been kidnapped. When I knew him many years ago, he loved Nigeria so much. But today his narrative has changed because the reality is on the ground. But that is not why we are here. Why I'm here is to play a clip. It's an audio clip where Mbaka, a few hours ago, have called for the man in Aso Rock to resign. Very, very important. So this clip is important that we all be part of it. A few hours ago, Mbaka have called for the man in Aso Rock to resign. And if he refuses to resign, that he should be impeached. It's important that we take this clip. If you are joining us, please share this program, invite your friend, tag your friends. It's going to be an audio clip, and we're all going to sit down. I'm not going to take much of your time. But I'm going to also give people opportunity to call in, make their contribution, because what we are about to hear is something amazing. Believe you me, it's something amazing, because the Simon Baka also told us that God told him that that the man in Aso Rock is the man that he has put there as the savior. And today he has come to defend himself with Bible quotations that, you know, God has sent him, but that doesn't mean that he has to be the one to, you know, govern on the behalf of the man in Aso Rock. Even though the man in Aso Rock, Buhari, we know is dead, that is a replacement. I think that at some point, Mbaka too will come out, because with the way things are going now, they are no longer giving him tithe and offering. They are no longer coming to his church. Even when he called them, they no longer pick his call. So this is a personal battle, between a running battle between Mbaka and the politicians. And it's important that we bring it to light so that our people will be looking at, you know, how religion has been used as an instrument to cage a lot of our people who are still today, you know, hoping and believing that God is the man who is deciding their destiny in Nigeria. You know, the politicians have used religion. At some point in this program, we told you that the politicians and the pastors and reverend, they are working together. They use the platform, they give them the altar to campaign. And when they campaign, at the end of the day, when they win election, they return back to pay. And today we've seen Mbaka a few days ago saying that Hope Uzodinma played him 419. That just typical fraudster that Hope Uzodinma is. When they chop you, they off their phone. Even when you call them, they will never respond. So that is what happened in the case of Mbaka and Hope Uzodinma. That in fact, the whole of Mbaka is now at war with the entire APC structure, because they use his platform. He feel they used him. They used and dumped him, and today he's firing back. So it is important that we bring this analysis to you so that our people will understand that we should outgrow this point. Today, the adoration ministry is even, you still have a lot of people shouting hallelujah in adoration ministry, you know, believing that God is there with them. You know, these are the things we need to let our people understand, that you can worship God in your houses. Even worshiping God is in the spirit. You can worship him in truth and the spirit. You don't have to go under any roof or under any pastor. You can worship God even in your house in sincerity, you know. So you don't have to allow the so-called Reverend Father men of God to use you and dump you. Today, Mbaka have also been used and dumped by Buhari when he was alive, because the man in Aso Rock is not Buhari as we speak, but Mbaka, I believe, at some point will come out to tell us the truth.
Nigeria, why please, are you crying?
Please, let's take it easy. I'm going to play the clip, and that we are all going to enjoy it. If you have coffee, if you have tea, if you have a glass of water, keep it by your side, because we are going to talk about it, and I'm also going to open the line for those who want to call in, so that we interact. This is an interactive forum. Share this program in every platform. Make sure it go around. We are going to play this audio. It's a very, very interesting one, because most of the things Mbaka said here are realities. I believe that he has beginning to, you know, every disappointment is a blessing. He has been disappointed by these politicians, and he's not beginning to see the fault, because if they were coming to him, giving him his own share of the national cake, he can never speak against them. But today, they have disappointed him, and that disappointment by the politician have become a blessing, you know, giving him the courage, in fact, the frustration to speak up. And I believe that by the time we finish with today's, this night interaction, a lot of our people who are still in the dark will start seeing clearly. So let's listen And I hope if the audio is not clear, please indicate on the comment section. But I believe the audio should be clear because I have a louder speaker, and I want you to take your time, hold your glass of water, a glass of wine. No, it's already late for those who are within my time zone. But if you are in other time zone, you can hold your glass of wine. Let's enjoy the preaching by Father Camilius Mbaka. Let's go, guys.
We are crying because our leaders have felt like God will ask Nigerians, why are you crying? We are crying because our leaders have failed us woefully. Let me tell you, if it is in a civilized country, by now, President Buhari will resign. Put me anywhere and let the whole world hear it. By now, with what is happening, President Muhammadu Buhari should honorably resign. We are crying because we don't have a shepherd. All those that will fight what I'm saying now will eventually suffer the rot. If you can't do it, either you resign or you'll be changed. A good coach cannot watch his team defeated when he has players sitting down watching at the bench. Either Buhari resigned by himself or he will be impeached. This statement is too mysterious and supernatural. I know that many people begin to fight it. Mbaka, did you not pray for Buhari? Did someone not anoint Saul? What are you talking about? Am I the creep?
Now you can see that he knows that he contributed to the problem. He contributed to, you know, convincing his followers possibly to vote for Buhari while he was alive. And he's using the biblical quotation to talk about how Samuel anointed Saul. And, you know, at the end of the day, we all know what happened in that biblical story. And I think, you know, the story is long because it's almost about almost 50 minutes, almost an hour clip. But we are going to take part of it, and I'm going to open the line for people to call in. Let's continue from where he stopped.
God created him. Nigerians trusted him because he did well sometimes. But now, how can people be dying? The chief security officer, consulting of lies of the country, will be sitting down not making any comment.
Buhari cannot make any comment because Buhari is dead. That is one thing Mbaka haven't come out to tell us. Mbaka is complaining that people are dying and Buhari is not making comment. We all know the Buhari, when he was alive, Buhari was a very, 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 very outspoken person. Buhari was never shy in the media. Buhari was never shy, you know, in confronting the media. In fact, Buhari was a very, very vocal person while he was alive. And today, Buhari can no longer speak. The Buhari we know that used to speak out, that stood very strong to condemn everything that Goodluck Jonathan, you know, did and achieved. So I'm going to see if I'm able to find some Buhari's clip, you know, because it's very, very important that our people start understanding that we have gone past all these stories. But Buhari that we know was an outspoken man. He was never afraid to confront the press. He was never afraid to speak out. He was never afraid to hold press conferences. And Buhari cannot be alive, and people are dying, and people are dying, and he's not speaking out. You know, so Father Mbaka, I think you need to come out with the reality and tell us the truth. That it's either you are not aware, but I think that You cannot deny you are not. Let's take a clip of Buhari when he was alive and see the boldness of Muhammad Buhari while he was alive. The boldness, in fact, he was a man who spoke out while he was alive.
This country is insecure. This country is getting bankrupt. It is mainly because of corruption and incompetence. What the APC is out is to make sure that we stabilize this system of multi-party democratic system by voting the PDP out.
Yeah, so when you see this clip of Buhari speaking, you see a man who was never shy, who was never afraid of the press. So how come he suddenly changed, he's now dodging, he doesn't want to have confrontation with the press, he no longer want to have anything to do with the press? Is it not strange to you that suddenly the Buhari who spoke out at some point, when he even looked unhealthy, have suddenly become so healthy but incapacitated? How possible is that? That the Buhari who even when he was, you know, wasn't too strong, spoke out, he was bold in nature, have suddenly gone deaf and dumb, you know, and looking even younger. He's supposed to be more agile, he's supposed to be more effective now because he looks younger, like a 40-year-old. In fact, Buhari's hand is fresher than my own here. You know, Buhari's hand is fresher than my own. But suddenly, the same young Buhari, who is today younger than the old one, have become, less effective. So Father Mbaka saying that Buhari is silent, it means that he's not yet ready to tell us the reality in full details. Or maybe he doesn't know. I can't blame him. So let's take, let's
amen.
Continue.
I'm taking everybody everywhere. Amen. Why are you crying, Nigerian youth? As I said, overseas have become dumping ground for our ingenious youth. Young men, young doctors, lawyers, everybody running away from Nigeria. Countries were better off. I'm just coming back from Ebonyi to this place. You need to visit Ebonyi. The former Abakiriki is not my Abakiriki. Ha!
Now, you see, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu have been complaining about the situation in Ebonyi for a very, very long time. And most of our people are not paying attention. Now, Mbaka is confirming that Ebonyi is no longer the Ebonyi we used to know. Things have deteriorated so bad. Fulanis have taken over the whole place. They have built the Afiko today. They have built the biggest school there in Afiko, the biggest Islamic school. And they are talking about expanding. And this Islamic institution have become a threat to the community, have become a threat to that environment. The Islamic school have come under scrutiny because it is alleged that that place has become a dumping ground for terrorists. That Islamic school in Ebonyi have become center of training and breeding young terrorists, upcoming terrorists like Issa Pantani and co. You know, so Mbaka said he went to Ebonyi and he was surprised with what he saw, that Ebonyi have lost its glory as a result of the Islamic agenda. Let's go ahead.
Even the leaders of Enugu State should wake up, because by the time Anambra State has her own cargo passengers airport and Ebonyi has her own airport, I don't know the reason why people should be coming to Enugu apart from prayer here. So if anybody speaks about development, let the government not begin to attack the person. They should change. Even with the mega resources that boy is getting, a boy will have mega projects flying over here and there. International centers. Anambra is the evolving 10,000 seaters international conference center. If I refuse to tell the truth, the Holy Spirit will attack me. So Father Mbakanam is backing. I'm rowing back to what I'm saying. What is the matter? Nigerians are crying. Why? Because there is no security in this country.
This state now that he's calling Ebonyi, Anambra, these are possibly the state governors that are still paying him tithe and offering, contributing to development of his ministry. You know, so it is also within his power to promote their project. You know, it is natural that those who you reap where you sow, and he's promoting Ebonyi, Devomahi, promoting, even though we know that these governors are not doing nothing in those states, compared to the resources available to them, but he's promoting them because, of course, they have been able to show appreciation, contributing, possibly paying him tithe and offering and all that. So it is not a surprise. Let's go on the aspect of insecurity.
House of Reps and representatives should impeach the president if he doesn't want to resign. Number two, if the members of the house, these two houses, do not want to impeach him and they want to begin to fight for them back, something worse than what they never imagined will happen to the members of the House of Senate and members of the House of Reps. Disaster is coming. A message released many years ago. Until the government of this country finds something useful for our youth, they are going to face disaster. A time is coming when, if you are asked to be a governor, a senator, a House of Reps member, a House of Representatives, whatever, you will begin to run. Because I'm trying to tell you that we cannot continue like this. The leaders have suffered the youth. Now it's time for the civilians, the ordinary people, to suffer the leaders. Enough of
now, Mbaka is indirectly supporting the activities of the unknown gunmen. Mbaka have been able to prove to the world, telling the Nigerian leaders that you have created monster in the youth. He doesn't want to come out openly to say it, but he said that at some point that these unknown gunmen you see today will start chasing this leader, this politician, that even when they say come and become governor, you will be the one on the run. So Mbaka is indirectly sending a message to Nigerian leaders, politicians, that the gunmen are here and they cannot escape from the run.
This rubbish. Most of the reasons why you come here for prayers are not prayer projects. These are what the government should supply. To buy one cup of rice now, to buy one cup of curry, to cook one pot of soup for a family, to pay for house rent, even to import their project products from abroad. Taxation has doubled how much? International communities cannot come to Nigeria to invest anymore. Are we living or are we dying? God is asking, what is the matter? I, as a servant of God, I'm telling God what is the matter. Let him change our leaders for us.
Yeah, so Father Mbaka is, he have already told you that the civilians, that it is in your hand. It is in your hand to bring the change. He doesn't want to, you know, as, you know, with the position he occupies, he might not come out to tell you because they will consider it inciting violence. But Father Mbaka is beginning to send coded messages to me and you that the government have failed. And it is in our duty to answer the call that Mazin Nnamdi Kanu have been calling us since, for a very long time now, to rise up. If Father Mbaka is indirectly calling for revolution, but he doesn't want to target revolution, but he's indirectly calling for revolution. And yesterday we listened to Mazin Nnamdi Kanu directly calling for revolution. When you listen to this clip, you understand the direction he's going. But, you know, he doesn't want to come out open, but we are here to interpret his words to you. Let's continue.
How can somebody become a billionaire from what belongs to all of us? And those who have the money are begging. Many mothers here cannot change pampers for their children. Our young ladies are thinking of going into prostitution. But who is going to prostitute you? Young men have nothing to you. And what is happening has evolved a satanic culture of immorality in the issue of occultism and idolatry. Young men now have started visiting native doctors, preparing charms. The job of the government is now to be killing people, calling them terrorists, instead of giving them jobs.
Now, we can listen to what Father Mbaka said here. I want our people to understand that I'm not here to project Father Mbaka. You leave Father Mbaka and take the message. I've seen somebody say I'm trying to make Father Mbaka relevant. Leave Father Mbaka. We are here to show you the message. Now, Father Mbaka have come out to tell you that instead of government to listen to young people, they are tagging them terrorists. He just said it now. That is to tell you that the fight we are fighting is a just cause. Father Mbaka is indirectly endorsing the activities, the agitation that you see today. Saying that instead of government to engage, they are tagging young people terrorists. And you can hear it from his mouth. Let me see if I can replay it again. Let's see.
Happening now. But if the government will not sit up and do what they should do, begin to roll out the money they pack preparing for 2023, that 2023 may not come.
Father Mbaka is assuring the politicians that they might never even see the 2023. And that is the projection everybody is giving, that 2023 is not going to happen. So Father Mbaka is telling you that you should continue to put the pressure you are putting to in fact, everybody that is involved in making sure that the institutions are broken down completely so that we all start afresh. Father Mbaka is telling the politicians here that they might never even live to see 2023.
It will be a story of tragedy. I plead that the church leaders will understand me as a messenger of God and not begin to fight me, because the danger is going to affect the church. When gunmen begin to strike inside the church, they will begin to kill one man of God or the other man of God and kill members of the church. Who will go to church again? The priests will lose their jobs. The bishops will lose their jobs. So you better keep quiet or you support what I'm saying, because it's evolving from the order of truth and righteousness. Everybody will soon be affected.
Three days ago, we came to this program and we were telling people that people who are, Obasanya Olam is not my business. Mbaka is now telling you that very soon everybody will be involved. Now, Anagabolo Potopoto, that you wouldn't even see where to put your leg. You would even, that your Hummer Jeep that you are driving, you wouldn't even see the door to open to enter that Hummer Jeep. That is what Mbaka is trying to say here, that is going to involve everybody very soon, including the church. So even the Mbaka himself is now beginning to realize that he needs to start standing on the path of truth. Let's hope that he sustains this truth, because he is afraid that the unknown gunmen might visit him very soon, just like he said, that the unknown gunmen will start visiting men of God, pastors, churches. Those pastors that have been deceiving people, those pastors that have caged the mind of our people, those pastors that have released their pulpit, that have used their pulpit as center for political purposes. I believe and I hope that Mbaka will continue on the path of telling the truth that he has started today and continue to call for the disintegration. In fact, I hope that Mbaka start from henceforth, start calling for total disintegration of the zoo called Nigeria. But Mbaka is advising the men of God that have been using the brain of our people to drink garri, that very soon unknown gunmen will visit them. That if they choose to fight him, that they are going to lose as well, because at the end of the day, that unknown gunmen is going to fight them. So all these things are coming as a result of him being used. So that is what I say, that every disappointment is a blessing. When I say every, so now Mbaka have been disappointed, used and dumped, and Mbaka is now beginning, it's like he's not becoming a blessing to the downtrodden. He's beginning to speak the truth as a result of disappointment from Aso Rock. He was used by APC to create a false prophecy narrative before the ascension of the Supreme Court Administrator of Imo State. Mbaka was instrumental in installing Uzodinma, the Supreme Court Administrator, as the governor of Imo State. He first of all was used to project that spiritual, make that spiritual projection. You know, because the cabals understanding how religious our people are, Mbaka was used to create that impression that Hope Uzodinma had been chosen by God to be the next governor of Imo State. Mbaka played a vital role in that, you know, specific aspect. But, you know, Hope Uzodinma, being a front star that he is, you know, as a Yahoo man, he's not a Yahoo boy, a Yahoo man, when the Yahoo people, when they finish dealing with you, they will dump you, change their phone number, or even when you call them, they will no longer respond. And this is what happened in this case with Hope Uzodinma, a typical 419er, that is their trait in character. And Mbaka have come out to express his disappointment that, you know, he actually was instrumental in making Hope Uzodinma who he is, and today he has been used and dumped, including even the people in the cabals in Aso Rock. They have finished with him, they have dumped him, and today he's coming out to tell them that since you have dumped me, God have brought also a message for you. Let's continue.
How can our children be killed? Just listen, you hear about killing. Nobody is safe again in this country. Do you think you are safe? Ask your neighbor, do you think you are safe? Do you think you are safe? Nobody is safe. Only God is protecting us. Hagar, what is the matter? Why is Ishmael crying? Why should this man not cry? Abraham was a very rich man. Abraham had everything it takes to settle Ishmael and Hagar. Why should Abraham give only one bottle of water to Ishmael and Hagar? Why should they not cry? We are crying because we are dehumanized. We are crying because we are intimidated. Our rights have been denied us.
Now, Mbaka is crying because he has been used and dumped. But he wants to put himself along with the crying populace so that also they will understand his, you know, they will understand that he too has become part of those that are not benefiting from the government. The politician used him, they used his pulpit. We saw Ganduje of Kano using Mbaka pulpit, despite the fact that Ganduje is not a Christian, a hardcore Islamist. But at the point that they needed the vote of Mbaka church members, they all took the pulpit with blood in their hands, touched the microphone, spoke to people, and they even were even sowing seed. And I believe that why Hope Uzodinma actually no longer is no longer picking what is it called, Mbaka's phone or not calling him again, is because of Hope Uzodinma believe that he has settled him. Because in that program where Hope Uzodinma was there, Hope Uzodinma sowed seed, which I believe because Mbaka said that Hope Uzodinma had made promise. So I believe he must have sowed the seed, and that deal is closed. As far as Hope Uzodinma is concerned, he has sowed seed, and that deal is closed. But Mbaka wanted to extend the relationship, you know, believing and hoping that, you know, things would be remitted. And Hope Uzodinma himself is not ready to play in that direction. And today, two of them are having their squabbles. That is another part of the story. But now we see Mbaka trying to be part of the oppressed now. He's saying it here that he's oppressed. He's been denied his right. That his right had been denied. This same Mbaka was sometime in the past who told us that we are not oppressed. That we are never oppressed. That we own buildings, we own properties in Kano, we own everything in Nigeria. That we are business people. That we are never oppressed. That we are doing very well. Today, the same Mbaka have not turned around to say that we are oppressed, that our rights have been denied us. Let us continue. In fact, we are bringing these issues. A lot of people will say Mbaka. It's important because when they speak and change their words from time to time, you remind them so that people who are following them will also see clearer, and also who people who intend following them will see clearer. Because that is what makes the difference between these people and our leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. What Mazi Nnamdi Kanu said 12 years ago is what he's still saying today. And that is what makes a man. Let's continue.
Opportunities that belong to our fellow Nigerians have been denied. Those we sent to represent us are using our names to make themselves billionaires. They are using our words to buy structures outside the country. What does it take to fix power in this country that industrialization will spark off? We have millions and millions of graduates doing nothing. And the leaders are not ashamed. What industrial projects have they created? Why should a mother and father, after training their children, continue to feed the children they train? When I heard this, I want to get verse 2, the Bible saying, you shall eat the fruit of the labor of your hands, and it shall be well with you. Are our parents now eating the fruit of the labor of their hands? They got in the real room for Ibarra. You can imagine why our parents are dying young. Teachers are not well paid. Even the policemen and the military are not taken care of. How do they have the effrontery and the courage to begin to protect the subjects? If you are killed as a police or a military man, nobody takes care of your family.
You see, Mbaka have reminded those working for the zoo, policemen. If you are a police officer, if you are an army officer, Mbaka have told you that if anything happened to you on that checkpoint that you are mounting, on that, in that police station where you are, oh my God, I feel bad. For people who are risking their life in the name of police and army for Nigeria, when you know that your life doesn't even matter. As a police officer, as an army officer, your life doesn't matter. Your life means nothing. The politicians are only using you for their own continuous progress. At the end of the day, you are dead, you are killed, and your family is not even taken care of. This is what Mbaka is saying. He's sending also a message to the men, Nigerian policemen and military men who are risking their life trying to protect this failed entity called Nigeria. Let's continue.
What type of country is this? Shall we continue like this?
Mbaka say we shall not continue like this. And this is what Mazi Nnamdi Kanu had been saying. In fact, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu's program yesterday, he was saying that we cannot continue like this. The same revolution that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is calling for is what Mbaka is calling for now. Mbaka is saying it is time for revolution. He doesn't need to say it, but indirectly, he has said it. It is time for revolution. The people need to rise. We need to rise. Everybody need to rise. We must leave Mbaka and take the message.
As far as I'm concerned, I can never support terrorism. Neither will I allow you to brand our children terrorists when they are not. If some people broke the prison in Owerri, if you caught those who broke them, arrest them, interrogate them. It may be possible that no human being broke that cell. It could be jailbreak from God. It happened in
Now we see that Mbaka is telling you that IPOB, the proscription of IPOB, Mbaka is now speaking, saying, why should you proscribe our children? Is referring to IPOB now. Why should you proscribe them terrorists? He's questioning the Nigerian government. He's questioning the Eastern governor. He's questioning Ohanaeze Ndigbo. Why should you proscribe IPOB? And he also talked about the prison break in Owerri. That prison break is the art, is a work of God. Because that such a prison break also happened in the book of Acts, Acts of Apostles. Let us listen what Father Back have to say about the prison break in Owerri.
The Apostles chapter 5. There was a jailbreak. Nobody was arrested.
Mbaka said that when there was a jailbreak in the book of Acts, Acts of Apostles chapter 5, in the book of Acts of Apostles, chapter 5, in the Bible, there was a jailbreak and nobody was arrested. So why are you now arresting innocent people over the jailbreak in Owerri? This same jailbreak have been happening even in the days of the Bible. Mbaka is telling Eastern governors that the jailbreak that happened in Owerri happened in the book of Acts of Apostle, chapter 5. So why should you go about, when Ikonso was killed, they accused Ikonso of participating in the jailbreak with no evidence, no proof. He was not interrogated. He was not asked any question. He was completely murdered for a jailbreak which the young man knows nothing about. And Mbaka is asking them, why should you kill Ikonso for a jailbreak? But this is not, because it's not the first time that jailbreak have ever happened. Jailbreak have been happening even in the days of the Bible. Let's continue from where Mbaka stopped here.
God can set the prisoners free. So for people to begin to go around and begin to kill our young men without trying them is evil. I'm just warning our governor, so it's not a matter of go and work for Mbaka, go and work for Mbaka. He has started the game. Are you the one who ordained me a priest? Are you the one who ordained me a prophet? Did you ordain me a king? Are you the owner of my mouth? If you, when you were doing well, was I not clapping for you? Now my fellow Nigerians are dying like rats without anybody caring for them. God is angry with our leaders. From Buhari to the last, God's anger is upon you.
Now Mbaka is beginning to make the politicians, including the dead Buhari, because the person representing Buhari, Naingo, using head carrier, the cabals in Aso Rock, that God is angry. God is angry with all of you. The unknown gunmen are here, and you cannot escape it. God have sent angels to revenge the death of the innocent. God have sent angels to revenge the death of the victims. This is the message Mbaka is speaking, because he can see the handwork of God, that the time he said that if any of you want to fight him, that you should come with you, that he's ready. Mbaka is telling the politician that this time around he's ready for them.
You have failed God. How can you just open your mouth like what Hopus of the man is doing in Imo State? Someone who came here and put his hand on this altar and swore he will protect the life of the Imolites is now organizing the killing of the same Imolites, and he wants me to keep quiet. I was keeping quiet until the blood of my brothers are being shed. Never.
You see, when the leaders of IPOB blamed or accused Ihope Uzodinma and Obi Ozo for the death of Ikonso, a lot of people didn't understand, but here we are. Ihope Uzodinma called for airstrike of the people of Imo because he suspected there was a ESN camp around that area. Ihope Uzodinma have, in a very short period of time, have created a situation where Imo State had become ungovernable. That today, a lot of strange things are happening in Imo State. And Mbaka is here saying that Ihope Uzodinma came to his altar to make a vow that he's going to bring peace and progress to Imo State. But today, Ihope Uzodinma have brought disaster. A man, he prophesied and told us that he's the man that God is bringing. Oh my God, that hope is the hope of Imo's. Today, the same God is now turning around to say that hope is hopeless, that hope is useless, that the hope that Mbaka said he said that it's not God. Mbaka is not telling you that it is not God that sent hope. But let's continue to listen and see if there are some other revelations and things we need to learn. Leave Mbaka, let us take the message. Very, very important. Because most of the things he's saying here are some of the things that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu have been saying all these years. And it baffles me that most of the people who disagreed, who abused Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, are now beginning to speak in the same revolutionary voice. Mbaka have become a revolutionary overnight. And we must take it seriously.
And whether we support that, we suffer. How can the military, the police, the SS, how is it difficult for you to arrest one person? What if the person you kill is innocent of what he's accused of?
Now he's talking about the death of Ikonso. How can military, combined police, a force, military, army, everybody cannot arrest one person? They have to murder him. Mbaka is making case for our comrade, our brother Ikonso here, who was murdered by the military, the police, combined ESS. Why didn't they arrest him and try him for the charges they put on him? Why should they? That is what Mbaka is questioning. Why should Ikonso be killed? We must take the message seriously. Mbaka is asking, why should Ikonso be killed? We must continue.
You killed Ikonso. You are parading his body all over, as if to say you have done whatever. Go and keep poverty. Keep poverty for us. Kill unemployment for us. Kill insecurity for us. You know how to kill wicked people. No! God's anger is on. as soon as possible, we give the whole governors mandate to begin to tell us the plans they have to give the whole youth job within a minimum time before it is too late. I don't belong to any human cult. Please, don't misunderstand me. If the Holy Family, Holy Trinity, God the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit is a cult, then I belong there. But within the context of what is happening, no prophet will be spared from God if he keeps quiet. Elijah cannot be happy with me. Elisha cannot be happy with Anambaka. Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, they cannot be happy with me. Moses and Joshua will not be happy if they notice that Anambaka is silent in what is happening. So it is time for me to open up. It shall not continue like this.
Mbaka said it is time for him to open up, because that means that for a long time he has been keeping certain things to himself. Just like so many pastors, so many reverends, so many men of God have been keeping a lot of things to themselves. And we are encouraging each and every one of them. It is time for other men of God to do the same part of Mbaka today. And start speaking up, start condemning. All the men of God should rise up and condemn the killing of Ikonso, who is practically innocent. Because you cannot, a man is innocent until found guilty. Ikonso remained innocent until found guilty. And this is what Mbaka is saying, that the death of Ikonso is completely unjustified and unjustifiable and completely unaccepted. And there will be consequences. Mbaka have said it, that there will be consequences for such action. We are not talking about his past. We are not talking about what he has said before. We are talking about what he's saying now. And if he still contradicts himself tomorrow, we'll still bring him to the public. But for now, this is the message that Mbaka have. Mbaka is calling for revolution.
My people jobs, give them food to eat, stop killing them, keep them busy positively. As for all, some of you governors funded them and equipped them with guns when you were going out for your campaign. Is what you bought that you are receiving. You think by killing them, everything will end. You are pouring fuel inside the fire. So the whole governor should come out publicly and apologize to the youth and have strategic plans on how to take care of this country, because there is no reason why the border should be opened. If you know the people coming into this country now, Niger and whatever, confusion everywhere. So nobody can now solidly accuse A or B of doing something, because you're not sure. The leaders have failed. So if what you are thinking of is to continue to perpetuate this satanic anachronism of increasing poverty in this country from 2023. Which is 2023? Things will be happening that nobody can stop. Until the leaders tell us the truth, why they should be sitting down and the desert in Dubai is turned into the best city in the world. With all we have, oil. Are they telling us the truth about that oil? The past and present leaders. It's not a matter of saying, thank God that no more a governor. All of you who have to make this thing to prepare this fire that is burning Nigerians, you should begin to restore. But that's wrong. All the monies that they looted that are being restored, where are they? Who is looting the loot? Here's the Renori, who is there? No, the Bulgaria. Because it is now pragmatically clear that the person we thought is our president is keeping silent when people are dying. It can never happen anywhere except in Nigeria.
Because Buhari is dead. The person is the Nasu Rock is not Buhari. Just a moment, please, guys. Let me. Guys, sorry, there was an interruption. You know, it's already late night here, and the noise is so high, and people around me, I have to ring the bell to tell me to reduce the sound of my voice. So I have to try to reduce the sound of my voice as much as I can, but I believe that if the sound is okay, please let me know. If it's not coming out clear, please also let me know. If not, we'll continue tomorrow, but I'll try as much as possible to continue this program till the end. It's already almost 2 a.m. here, and my neighbor is right to have rang the bell for me. So that was why I took that short break. So I hope that will continue from where Mbaka stopped. Yeah. So let's continue, please. Let's continue.
So if what you are thinking of is to continue to perpetuate this satanic anachronism of increasing poverty in this country from 2023, which is 2023? Things will be happening that nobody can stop. Until the leaders tell us the truth. Why? They should be sitting down, and the desert in Dubai is turned into the best city in the world. With all we have, oil. Are they telling us the truth about that oil?
I hope the line, I hope it's clear. I hope that you can hear what Father Mbaka is saying. Hope you can hear what Father Mbaka is saying. Okay.
The doctor was saying, time goes and no more government. All of you who helped to make this thing, to prepare this fire that is burning Nigerians, you should begin to restore. But that's wrong. All the monies that they looted that are being restored, where are they? Who is looting the loot? Here's the Renori, who is there? No, the Bulgaria. Because it is now pragmatically clear that the person we thought is our president is keeping silent when people are dying. It can never happen anywhere except in Nigeria. Look at Nigerians giving thanksgiving because they got a visa to Ghana. A family came to give thanksgiving and are traveling to Ghana. Is it not shameful?
Nigerians are now testifying that they got visa to Ghana. Nigerians under Buhari, dead Buhari, under Fulani government. Nigerians, in fact, Ghana, I read in the news today that Ghana arrested hundreds of Nigerians, over 200-400 Nigerians, for staying illegally in Ghana. Ghana has become the hot spot now for Nigerians to travel abroad. Ghana has become abroad for Nigerians under Fulani. Visa to Ghana. You hear it from Fadambaka. Let's continue.
Because if we don't stop this thing that is going on now, if the leaders will not stop what is going on now, what is going on now will stop them. Live and let live. They are insatiable. How many more amount of millions or billions do you think you will acquire and you can now settle down? What excuses will the governor give us? They receive security posts every month. Do you know how many millions they receive every month for security posts? And some men of God will say, Mbaka, first your priestly work. Which one is my priestly work? My priestly work is to be a coward, to be silent when my people are dying.
Father Mbaka said that some of the politicians are even telling him to concentrate on his church work, that he should not come close to them, that he should not come to criticize them, that he should face his priestly work. You know, that he should not criticize them. And he's telling them that what he's doing now is part of the priestly work that he has to do, criticizing them. And this is what we are telling the pastors, the men of God, all over the place, that part of your duty is to criticize, speak the truth. How can you be a pastor and you say and you see this kind of atrocities going on in the land, and all you are shouting is one Nigeria, Nigeria will not break? We've seen the likes of Kumuyi, Oyedepo, all these big men of God, rather than coming out to speak the truth and condemn the devil, they are busy telling you that we must all die in one Nigeria, because they are afraid that if Nigeria break, that the newfound nation might not give them the opportunity. Because when Nigeria finally disintegrates, all the countries that come out of Nigeria will not allow the mistake that was made in Nigeria to repeat itself. They will no longer allow religion to be an instrument where you now open churches to deceive people and take tithe and offering. There is going to be a lot of new regulations. And these big men of God who have established big churches would not be able to meet up with the new regulations that the Oduduwas are going to put in place for religion, that the Biafrans are going to put in place for religion, and the Arewas are going to put in place, and for every other nation that will come out of Nigeria. Because all these new nations are going to take precaution of the damage religion did to Nigeria and make sure it doesn't repeat itself in the new nation. Where people go to church from Sunday to Sunday without work, these new nations will never allow that to happen. And this big man of God knows that when Nigeria disintegrates, people will no longer give them the opportunity to use their citizens the way they are using them in Nigeria today. So when you hear them talk about keeping Nigeria one, because their ministry can only survive in an environment like Nigeria. These big men of God, their ministry can only survive in an environment, in a polluted environment like Nigeria. Their ministry cannot survive in a sane, clean, regulated, well-structured environment. So they know what they are doing. So when you see them say they want one Nigeria, when you see Kumu, he say he's praying for Nigeria to remain the same. He knows that deeper life can only succeed in an environment like Nigeria. When you see Oyedepo saying that he's praying to, for Nigeria to remain the same. He knows that his mountain of fire or whatever can only succeed in an environment like Nigeria. So that is it. Let's continue with what Mbaka have to say here.
As I say, we did not the one who prayed for Rokos Adema. Rokos Adema was like a vision that came to me. This person is going to be the governor of Imo State. If you are in a dream and you see something, how are you involved in it? You have a vision and you call the person. I don't know his political story. Before you become who you, God says you're going to become. Do you know when he came here, he went and prayed in Abiquot? You know that? After coming here, Pope Osadema prayed in Abiquot. But the message continued that he will still be the governor. I don't know how. It was that how, I don't know.
Mbaka here is trying to, is not being sincere with us here. Mbaka cannot tell us that he doesn't know how Hope Uzodinma became the governor that God told him. God didn't tell Mbaka anything. It was all arranged. You know, on this angle, as much as I have accepted the angle of truth that Father Mbaka have told us in this preaching here, I will not accept the lies that he's telling us now. Because before Hope Uzodinma became the governor of Imo State, there was a connection in Abuja. And they said, who will be the right person to be used to, first of all, send the message? Who will be the right person that the people can listen to, that when he speaks from the spiritual angle, people will, you know, take it? So Mbaka was used as an instrument to calm the nerves of the people, because what happened was the cabals knew that there was no way number fourth position would have become number one if not for the hand of God in it. The cabals knows that there is no way fourth person will become one if there is no way they can link it that it is the work of God. And they needed somebody to do that. They needed an instrument. And Mbaka was used as an instrument to make it possible. Mbaka was used as an instrument to make that projection possible, because they understand that people of the Eastern region, majority, a lot of people listening to him, and he was used as an instrument so that when that court verdict finally comes out, people will say, but Mbaka saw it coming, that man of God saw it coming. They will not say it was the work of God, because there is no way, there is never anywhere in history where fourth person became first in an election. So the cabals knew that they needed to contain the riot, they needed to contain the demonstration, they needed to contain the people's emotion, and they needed somebody in the position of Mbaka to say that God said, so that people will say, as far as God have said, there is no longer nothing we can do as a people. That was what happened. So Mbaka coming to tell us that he saw it in a dream, I disagree with you, because we all know the truth. So you've told us very good things we needed to hear, but on this one we disagree with you, Father Mbaka. Let us continue.
I don't know. I am not a member of the Supreme Court. I don't know anybody in the Supreme Court. I don't know where the Supreme Court is. I don't talk with the Buhari. I don't have Buhari's phone number. People are just misunderstanding Father Mbaka. Look at me on the altar, putting my hands on this book of life. I don't have Buhari's number. I don't call him and he doesn't call me. People should stop misquoting me.
You cannot have Buhari's number Maybe you had it because Buhari is dead, by the way, and Mbaka knows that Buhari is dead. So how can you call Jubri? Jubri doesn't know you. The man in Aso Rock now doesn't know you. The person you know as Buhari is dead. You know, so if there is no way, even if you call Jubri now, Jubri will tell you, who are you? I don't know you. So it is very, very clear that even swearing with the Bible, you can be justified, because of course, there is no way you can have Jubril's number, because the Buhari, I mean, you had good relationship. There was a time you talked about Buhari and the family, how beautiful, how wonderful the wife and how gentle they are as a family, how humble. In fact, in that program, you portrayed yourself as a Buhari family friend, because I listened to it, where you were praising Aisha, praising the Buhari first son, that they are very humble, that they are spiritual people. The way you projected it, it was you, Mbaka, that projected that you have good relationship with the Buharis. So how can people now believe that you don't have their contact? How can you come to praise people you don't even know how their bedroom is? And you say, oh, that you talk as if you have been eating with them on the same table for a very long time. I listened to your program on Baka, where you were praising the wife of Buhari, Aisha, saying that, oh, the woman is so nice, that even the first son, the way you were describing it, anybody who listened to you will believe that you and these people eat on a daily basis every day. So how can you not come out to tell us that you don't? How can you come out to tell us that you don't have their phone number? Mbaka, I'm beginning to suspect you now. Don't change. Remain on the path of truth. And that is why I'm bringing this message, because so far you have been able to show that you are beginning to fall in line with our revolutionary views and understanding. But you have to come out clean. Come out clean. Nobody's going to harass you. We understand. It is you that made the whole world believe. In fact, many times you've said that you have visited Aso Rock. So when you visited Aso Rock, didn't you exchange number with Buhari? When Buhari was alive, you would have told us that the number you had, that you've lost it, or when Buhari was alive, that you had his number. That was what I was expecting to hear from you. That when Buhari was alive, that was what I was expecting to hear from Mbaka, that you had Buhari's number when he was alive. If you tell us that one, we can understand. Not that you don't have Buhari's number. You would have told us, when Buhari was alive, I had his number. I had contact with him, but this one in Aso Rock now, just like Hope Uzodinma. If you tell me that you came out to say that Hope Uzodinma no longer pick your call, we can understand. You would have told us that the one in Aso Rock now is not your friend. That the Buhari that you know, that you used to have his number. So don't tell us you don't have Buhari number because you had it before. But if you tell us that the one that you have now, that the one that is in Aso Rock now, that you don't have his number, we can understand. Don't tell us that you don't have Buhari number. Let us continue.
I'm just a messenger of God. If God tells me today, tell this father here, you're going to be the bishop of the diocese, and I prophesied it and go for my business. If eventually he becomes the bishop and begins to attack the priest, so you come in to punish me, even if I did not say it, he will still be the bishop. The message just passed through me. But somebody who became now the governor and up to today has not come to say that to God till today. Because I know that if Hope Bones of Every Man is receiving advice from this sanctuary, he will not be messing up. Those who are advising him have killed him while he's still alive. Once this man was dangerous, about Ugo, was with me in the temple, I got those numbers. Amadou was there. Odengere from Amadou was there. Although again, I was there listening when I saw the group. Maybe she's taking me, she didn't know it was me. May I tell her to God bless you? I could not come to say thanks to God. Don't see me. Although again, I was there. And I told him, even if you come with the money, I will not touch it. Just come here and say, God, thank you. Now go to Allah and go back. You need an advice from somebody who doesn't need anything from you. And their message is
Mbaka is telling us that his anger is a hope he didn't even come to thank God for. Because Mbaka is telling us now that Hope became the governor of Imo State through the prophecy of adoration ground, not by vote of the people, or even by. In fact, Mbaka is telling you that even the Supreme Court itself was not what made Hope the governor, that it was through his prayer and prophecy that Hope became the governor of Imo State. And how possible is it that Hope now refused to come and give thanks to God who made him the governor through the adoration ground? That even if Hope bring money today, that Mbaka will not take. So why are you connecting money? If you don't have interest in money, why are you connecting money with the thanksgiving? If you don't have interest, he said that even if Hope bring money, that he will not take. So why are you connecting money to the task given? The Hope have to pay God for making him governor of Imo State. He said that. Let's continue, please, guys. Let's continue. It's unfortunate that I'm doing this program at this time. It's already after 2 a.m. and tomorrow morning I have to apologize to my neighbors. But we have to finish this work this night. We must continue, guys.
Don't have an hand sweeping for Hope that didn't have. Nobody is employed through me. Like the Buhari, nobody is employed through me. I don't have any person packing something as the gutter for Buhari through but I'm back. People are just misunderstanding me. So it's better I come publicly and declare my stand. But that's by the way. What I'm trying to tell you is, why are you crying? We are crying because we have lost hope in our leaders. The issue of locking the government house gate, is that the solution? One governor will be moving with over 50 policemen. What about their subjects? If they are the shepherd, I think the shepherd should be protecting the sheep. Now the shepherd is protecting himself. If the sheep are dying, let them die. They must know they are our governors, he is our president, they are our senators and representatives because of us. Because of us. The youth are angry. The Nigerian soil is angry. The land of Nigeria is angry. So, whether they want to run, where are they running to? The land of Yoruba is the land hot and angry. Our land is angry too. Igbo land is hot and hot and angrier.
Now, Mbaka is beginning to appreciate what IPOB is doing. He's beginning to recognize the agitation of Oduduwa's. He's beginning to recognize the agitation of Biafra. He's beginning to even recognize the agitation of Northerners, that everywhere is hot now. And Mbaka don't have option than to speak out. Because anybody who refuses to speak now, you might never be alive to speak again.
They should better resign and hand over and define for us how this country shall be. The money they are stealing is not their money.
What Barker is saying now is exactly what Mazen Nnamdi Kanu said years ago, yesterday, just yesterday, that we should put pressure so that the government will collapse. That is what Barker is saying, that they should resign, all of them. And that is what Mazen Nnamdi Kanu just said. And I believe he must have listened to Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, because he's speaking in the same tune. He's speaking in the same tune. Mbaka want the government, everybody in the government, to be chased away. And that is the reality. He wants all of them to be chased away. Let's continue.
Some of us who used to visit prisons will tell you that some people are in the prison because they stole 10 naira. But our leaders who stole billions of naira are being secured with police and army. Who should be in your prison? Insofar as I don't know those who broke the prison, I don't know where our prison is. I'm not a jailbreaker. But if anybody is angry that the prison is broken and nobody is there, go there and stay. If you like prison, even Gadigan, or give a gun, or to get a cane. But yes, you get what I tell you. Everything is not the way we. Yes, Alessandro, yes, Alessandro, no, yes, Alessandro, it's because, yes, Alessandro, these are psychopaths, boot lickers. That was in a natural make. Naturally, one raise your boot that you have failed us. How many houses will you have and you are satisfied? Many poor Nigerians cannot pay for one room house rent. Many cannot pay for their school fees. All the lies told about our ecological fund, who is the people who?
You know why Mbaka is getting mad now at Hope Uzodinma? Because when unknown gunmen visited Hope Uzodinma's house, the Rolls Royce that was discovered in Hope Uzodinma compound, 200 million naira worth of Rolls Royce, packed in the village, 200 million naira worth of Rolls Royce was packed in Hope Uzodinma's village that to decorate the compound. And after that time, Mbaka became very, very angry. That was because Mbaka have kept quiet all this while till the visitation by unknown gunmen went to Hope Uzodinma's house in the village. And after that visitation, when Mbaka saw the 200 million naira Rolls Royce, he said, Kopuya, Osunodura possible.
We are just quiet and silent. I better protect my people and stand against the leaders than be with the leaders and not protect my people. So I am with my people. Enough of this rubbish. I want to tell them that the owner of the world is God. The president will come and go. Governors will come and go. Go to the House of Senate and Reps, chairman and whatever, they will come and go. Why can't the good enabling environment be given to our countrymen? Put it below. As I was saying on Sunday, it is not shameful that Hyundai and Kia will move to Ghana to settle. Ask the God for our brother innocent. Apart from that, do we have any assembling plan for car? How can a country be sitting on top power that loaded with a fire? What is happening now is a time bomb. Nobody knows how it will happen. Because we don't know who is the PDP and the APC. These are people who change their uniform. They are the same. It's only unicorns. They wear PDP by day, by night. They wear ABC. Others wear ABC by day, by night. They wear PDP. Who is telling who? That is the matter. Nigeria has the best youth in the whole world. There is no country you can find such numbers of ingenious youth. Put them anywhere. They will come back. One secondary school in Anambra went to competition last time abroad. They came first. The US. And I told my master, oh my God, I said, oh, American, I said, I'm not going to go. Oh, my God, I'm going to go. I'm going to go. If you support them, they create rules for you. If you support them, they do this for you. If you don't support them, I can never support them. We are not supporting you to disobey God and mess up the country.
Hope the voice is coming out clear, guys. Hope the voice is coming out clear. Because very soon we'll be rounding up.
Some states are no longer paying their teachers. Some are not paying their workers. Some are not paying patients anymore. Somebody who have been working for years, now you come and say he's a ghost worker. Okay, the best is a ghost. Great job and employ the person somewhere because it is your duty. We are their children. So we lift up our hands.
Thank you, guys.
To God to bless us. Because when Abraham had given only one bottle to Hagar and Ishmael,
thank you guys, thank you guys.
To stay with one bottle. Genesis chapter 21, verse 19 said, when Hagar opened her eyes, she saw a well flowing with water. Our leaders might have given us only one bottle. God is going to open well for us. Are you ready for a well experience? Or are you still talking about the bottle? Just one bottle. Okay, one bottle. Just one bottle. You can have a headache in one bottle. Don't worry. Somebody here is going to experience an open world.
Obagona prophecy.
How it's going to happen, I don't know. When, I don't know. Through whom, I don't know. But you are lifting up our hands.
Obagona prophecy. So at this point, I don't think we need anything further from Father Mbaka. You know, because for me, I'm not going into that aspect. But what I want to bring to our people is that from Mbaka to turn around and start complaining after feeling used. You remember that when Jonathan was in power, Sowore played a very big role to make the dead Buhari president. And when the dead Buhari became president, Sowore was not settled. And today he turned around to fight the APC that he brought to power. And the APC themselves, understanding the power of the media, the role that he played in kicking Buhari out, they didn't allow him to play such a role with them. Excuse me, guys. They didn't allow Sowore to play the same, to use the same strategy on them. And today they have used court case to hang him. Today Sowore went to court and he was standing outside the court because the court is on strike. Sowore went to court today for his case, but the court was on strike, nobody in court. This is exactly what they did to Mbaka. They used him to manipulate the hopes of the man governorship, and after that they dumped him. But dumping him have now made him to start saying the truth, and we believe and I hope that he continue on the path of telling them the truth. Let him use that pain of the disappointment to confront those who have been killing us. For Mbaka to come out to make comment about Ikunso's death, that is to show you that he's not picking a direct fight with Hope Uzodinma. He's not using the death of Ikunso as an instrument of battle against Hope Uzodinma. And he has already seen that Hope Uzodinma have already no longer have any chances of remaining the governor of Imo State. Mbaka have seen it, that Hope Uzodinma's foot is no longer strong in Imo State. So he's also trying to use the same instrument to join hand to make sure that Hope Uzodinma leaves that position. Even though he was used, I believe that even some of the agreement they had, because he would not be, he would be too ashamed to say it about the promise they made him to carry that prophecy. Because if they have met up with that promise, he wouldn't criticize them. Why he's criticizing them today is because the promise they made him that maybe they must have bargained on if they use him to project Hope Uzodinma, that look at what they are going to do for his ministry. And I believe that they have failed in that promise. They have used him, they have dumped him, and they are no longer picking his calls. And that is why you can see him now fuming and angry. And today he's supporting revolution, supporting even unknown gunmen. First in history. So I want you to see that every disappointment, the disappointment of Mbaka by politicians, have made him start standing with the poor masses. Even though he is claiming that he had been with the poor masses since. No, if you can settle him, in fact, there is something he said in this, that none of them have even asked him to bring somebody for employment. That none of these politicians have asked him to bring people to be employed, and nobody is even cleaning gutter in the name of Mbaka with Hope Uzodinma or even with Buhari. That means they didn't give him employment slot. He said it, that he was not given any employment slot, that he knows not, you know, that his hands are clean. So these are the things they do. So if they had given Mbaka employment slot and he's able to put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 people, give them a job through Hope Uzodinma or through the presidency, he will never come out to criticize. He will never come out to criticize them. Because if he criticized them, they will sack those people that he gave them to work, to those people they employed through him. So these are the things they do. Mbaka said that they didn't give him any slot for him to bring people, to give people employment. So which means if they have maybe given him slot for people, for him to bring people to employ, you know, Mbaka indirectly told us his anger. In that, but the problem is our people don't pay attention to details. But he has indirectly told us his anger that he was used and dumped. So at this point, he's picking fight with all of them, because they made him to lie against the Holy Spirit. And this is where I'm going to bring the end of this program. Unfortunately, it's already late night here. It's past 2 a.m. here. But I told myself I was going to host this program. And I even promised I was going to take calls. But if we take calls now, is going to disturb my environment, you know, cause here and there. So we're going to leave it for possibly tomorrow. And I hope to be back tomorrow. And I also promise by that this weekend we'll be holding programs consistently. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, we'll try as much as possible to come here live with Mazi Solomon Peter to bring more analysis on other rising issues. But why I decided to play this audio clip with you is for you to understand that the activities of ESN have been loved by even our own enemies. Even our enemies are loving the work of ESN. People we did not expect will support ESN are supporting ESN. And today, in Ebonyi State, Ebubagu was launched. And one Yoruba boy was discovered as a personnel of Ebubagu. A Yoruba person was among the newly inaugurated Ebubagu, and his fellow Yoruba person identified him and called him out and said, are you an Igbo man? I didn't know you were an Igbo man. So how come you're answering Yoruba name? So it's something to be investigated as well. So if you have details of, it's already, if you go to my page, you see it. It's on my page. Let me see if I can get the details on my page of the Yoruba. The name of the Yoruba guy is Taiwo Akinfewa. You know, if you go to my page, you see him, they circled his face with red. His name is Taiwo Akinfewa, a Yoruba person recruited in Ebubagu security outfit. How many Igbos are in Amoteku? That is to tell you all you need to know. And I believe that over the weekend, all of us will be spending time together. His name is Taiwo Akinfewa. So if you have more details about him, you can come forward with it, because we need to expose the activities of these Eastern governors. Ebubagu, according to them, is an indigenous security outfit. So how come you are bringing a foreigner? And if he's an Igbo person, is he an Igbo person born in Lagos with Yoruba parents? Or we need to get more details, and they need to give us explanation to that. So guys, join me over the weekend. We'll be spending good time together. And I want to say thank you for being part of this program. And I'm happy to host you. I want to say have a wonderful evening, and God bless you all.